Welcome, everyone, to Saki Speakeasy Podcast. I'm your host, Saki Speaks, and I appreciate you giving me a bit of your most precious commodity, your time. Please show my moderator, Love Jones, some love and affection, moving in the right direction when she gets here, because she's at work. Y'all know she got a promotion, so love up on her when she gets here. And make sure that you've liked the video on your way in the door, and don't be afraid to drop in the chat box and say, hey, girl, hey. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel, making sure to click the notification bell and select all so you don't miss out on an opportunity to chill with us when the Speakeasy is open for business. Now, with that being said, welcome to all of my brand new sippers and speakers. Thank you so much for subscribing to the channel, and I hope that you find a reason to stick around. And welcome back to all of my wonderful returning sippers and speakers and those of you catching this on the replay. Thank y'all for coming back one more time to love up on your girl, because I can't seem to get enough of the way that y'all love on me. All right. So listen, happy hump day. Yeah, I was MIA for a minute, y'all. I had to take care of a little business, but a bitch is back and I'm ready to get into this next book, okay? I am excited. So let me see who's here so we can get started, all right? Because y'all know we're here for a good time and not a long time. And every time I say that shit, 46 hours later, no, I'm just kidding. But we do be up here for a good little minute, even though I don't be wanting to. Y'all, these videos be long as shit. All right. So, hey, Shanae, welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. Hey, Seti said, welcome, darling. I appreciate you being here. And you too, damn day. I saw you talking about old hump day ass bitch. Wait a minute. Was that from one of the ethic books or one of the butterfly books? I can't remember, but... I know Morgan asked Thomas, oh, hump day ass bitch. Was that Morgan or was that Alani? Child, I can't remember, but one of them have to say that shit. Anyway, welcome day. Hey, Felicity, thank you for being here, darling. I appreciate you, and you too, little mama, and you too, Danielle. Irk and Jerk is in the building with us, and Chef Sky, your first live stream. Y'all, welcome Chef Sky to the Speakeasy. Thank you for being here, darling. I appreciate you. My problem child is here, honey. Wifey. Hey, girl. Hey, girl. Welcome. Thank you for being here. I appreciate you. Hey, F girl. Thank you for being here, darling. And you too, Missouri. L Boogie in the building. Welcome, darling. Thank you for being here. I appreciate you. Cupcake 1981. Thank you for being a new subscriber. I appreciate you. Y'all welcome Cupcake to the building. I appreciate you for being here. Vicky is here in the building with us today. Welcome, welcome. I'm trying to go, Bella, Bella. Hey, girl, welcome. I was looking for you. Where you been? All right, but welcome, darling. Thank you for being here. Let me see. Wait a minute, F girl, tell my girl, I thought we broke you because we kept you too long on the last reading. We missed your humor and we're so glad you're back. Well, thank you, F girl. Don't be having me being all marshmallowy and stuff. I be trying to be hard up here, girl. You got to be hard. But yes, I took a little bit of time for me. And now I'm back and I'm ready to start this new book. So let me get this timestamp, child, because Lord have mercy. Oh, it was the first ethic book day. All right, well, child, thank you, because Lord have mercy. Oh my God. Y'all just don't know them books. Ooh, baby. And to think we got the new butterfly, child. I don't even know. Anyway, I got my timestamp waiting for a little bit of a countdown, and then we can get started. All right. Today, we're reading A Love Worth Fighting For, Cannon and Tiff by K. Renee. And the synopsis reads, "You can't compete where you don't compare" has never been truer than in Cannon and Tiff's situationship. Cannon swore that he would get Tiff by any means necessary. Things seemed to be going that way a few times, but Tiff just wasn't ready. Back in her hometown after moving, Tiff runs into Cannon, and it is not a happy reunion. Tiff has secrets that may result in her seeing a side of Cannon she's not prepared for. What secrets could Tiff possibly have? Will she be able to prove to Cannon that she's not the snake he thinks she is? Cannon also has his own family issues going on, trying to protect the ones closest to him. This leads to family issues that are hard to deal with. Two people close to both Tiff and Cannon take a chance at romance, but distance will make it hard. When tragedy strikes and flights are booked, things go from bad to worse in the blink of an eye. The truth will threaten to break up this new couple. Will they be able to figure out their new relationship? Everything that was done in the dark will come to light for these four. When feelings get involved and the trust isn't there, things escalate quickly. Will they be able to sort it out, or is it better to just leave things alone? So, child, listen. I think this one is going to be good, y'all. It's something about Cannon's ass. He remind me of somebody. Oh, my goodness. Anyway, let me be quiet. So, yeah. Hey, sweet coconut. I saw you coming here. Hey, girl. Hey, welcome. Thank you for being here, lovey. Oh, you changed your thing. I got your face up there. Hey, cutie. Okay, child. Listen. Oh, I got the cutest sippers and speakers, child. All right. Let me get this timestamp so we can get started. Y'all, I'm going to tell y'all right now, if this book ain't good by chapter 3, we are done and moving on. So y'all better cross y'all eyes, lips, fingers, arms, legs, toes, hair strands, not the follicles though, but just the strands. You could cross them that this shit is good, because I swear I'm going to be pissed off. I'm going to be pissed off if this shit is trash. All right. Oh, Lord, child. All right, here we go. I'm scared. Chapter 1, Cannon. Who is it? She yelled, swinging the door open with a scowl on her face. Damn, beautiful, you not happy to see me? What are you doing here? Better yet, how the fuck do you know where I live? I knew she was nervous by the way her voice trembled. I'm the man they call when a nigga needs to be found. Finding you was a walk in the park. At least I was nice enough to knock on a door, because a nigga like me don't like doorbells or knocking. That shit is annoying as fuck. How many times did you think I was gonna let your fine ass keep walking by me and not come for you and that sweet pussy you got between your thighs? Pulling her into me, I could feel her body tense up under my touch. She was nervous, and that shit made me smile on the inside. You need to leave. I've told you dick is not what the fuck I'm... I cut her off, lifting her up and pressing her against the door. Her breathing was short and erratic, and I was ready to tear little mama's life the fuck apart. I'm here to do one thing, and that's suck and fuck you until you can't scream my name no motherfucking more. I smiled. Put me down. She could barely get the words out, and all I could do was stare at her beautiful ass. Tiff was one of those women that you could look at, and your dick instantly got hard. Her caramel complexion, big ass, wide hips, and the sexiest mole right above her beautiful pouty lips, that shit was my weakness. The only time I'm putting you down is when you sliding down on this dick. You may think you like pussy, but reality is about to fuck your life up, and that's on me. I can't do this. Oh, she moaned as I slid my hand inside of her shorts, grazing my fingers across her fat ass pussy. If you want me to stop, I'll stop. The way this pussy soaking my fingers, I don't really think you want me to stop. I had to taste her. Pulling my fingers out of her and placing them in my mouth, licking her juices off, caused her to quiver. I could feel the fire building up inside of her. Sliding my tongue across her lips was all it took. She sucked that motherfucker into her mouth like it was a vacuum. Nothing prepared me for the shit that happened next. Damn near ripping the clothes off of each other to get what we both were starving for, sliding my dick back and forth across her wet pussy damn near made me nut prematurely. I knew then that I wasn't going to just be able to hit this shit one time and walk away. The moment I eased inside of her, she cried out like a wounded animal. I had to take it easy with her because I'm sure it had been a while since she had dick inside of her. Having a cannon inside of her can cause some serious fucking problems anyway. Once she adjusted to my size, she began moving up and down on my dick. Fuck, I growled in her ear as my strokes went deeper and deeper into her walls. It was almost as if my movements were uncontrollable. Oh, shit. I can't take it, she moaned as she held on tighter. Girl, you gonna take this dick and love that shit, I growled, deep stroking the hell out of her. Cannon, she cried out in ecstasy. That alone had me ready to tear her ass up and show her what the fuck she had been missing. What's up, beautiful? Just let me love on you tonight and we can talk about that other shit in the morning. I want to show you what it's like to be with a real man, not some little boy that got you running from dick to suck on a clit. That shit ain't you. Not the way your pussy is gripping my dick right now. Your ass been waiting on the right dick to come along to show you some real shit, and I got you, baby. There was no way I was gonna let her fine ass go after tonight. The days of her fucking with bitches were over. Fuck me. I need you to fuck me, she moaned. Walking over to the couch with her in my arms, she eased down on my dick, gyrating up and down on my shit. The real Tiff showed up and showed the fuck out on this dick. The fuck? I gritted as she started riding the tip of my dick and gripping my shit with her pussy muscles as she gyrated up and down on it. She repeated that shit for a while, and I swear a nigga was seeing stars. I have never been fucked like that before. Little mama and her pussy was gonna be a problem for me and her. Shit, I'm coming. But I couldn't form words to respond because the pussy was just that good. I just gripped her ass and fucked the cum right on up out of her beautiful ass. Fuck, this pussy is beasting. I came so damn hard, my ass was shaking like a little bitch. And that's when I realized that I wasn't wearing a condom. Fuck. Cannon, I know damn well you didn't just call me your ex-bitch name. Why the fuck I'm riding your motherfucking dick, Dina yelled. Fuck, I can't get this girl out of my fucking head. The whole time I was fucking Dina, I was thinking about the first time I slid up in Tiff. She was already feeling some type of way about my relationship with Tiff. I don't know what the fuck you talking about, I said to her, knowing that I probably slipped the fuck up. Nigga, you know exactly what the fuck I'm talking about. I'm sick of this shit with you and that dyke ass bitch. She was going off, and I can understand her anger, but she gonna watch her tone when she talking to me. Listen, my bad if that happened, but I don't recall saying no shit like that. I'm gonna need you to watch your damn mouth with all that name calling. We not together. I'm fucking with you the long way, and I respect you, so I apologize if I said some off-the-wall shit. The pussy was feeling good, and I guess I kind of blacked out. Pause. Sir, you don't black out and call another bitch name, my guy. You you supposed to black out and call the bitch name that you fucking. The fuck? What the hell? Like, I don't even understand. Oh, my God. I got up and walked into the bathroom, leaving her standing there with her thoughts. It's clear that the shit with me and Tiff is unresolved. I have to do something about it because the shit was driving my ass crazy. It's been a year since I've seen her at Nas and Cass's wedding. That shit was fucking torture. It took everything in me not to walk up on her that day and squeeze the air out of her body. That's a fucked up feeling to have about a woman that you would have given your life for without thought. The moment I buried myself into her, pieces of her soul just seeped into my body and found its resting place. I never expected to fall hard for her. It just happened, and now I'm regretting ever saying shit to her ass. Nas Priest and I have been friends for a long ass time, and I would hate to lose our friendship because I killed a cousin. So, the best thing for me to do is to stay the fuck away from her ass. I made this shit no secret on how I felt about the shit Tiff did to me. I hated saying her name because the shit left a bitter taste on my tongue. When I stepped out of the shower and walked back into the bedroom, Dina was gone. I guess she mad. I asked to be all right, and if not, oh well. I'd been messing with her for a couple of years, but my mind wasn't right to make her my girl. Truth be told, my heart was fucked up, and I could never trust another woman. After Tiff and I got a taste of each other, that damn girl was on my dick every damn day for almost 5 months. She wasn't fucking with no other chicks. It was just me and her, and I honestly couldn't get enough of her. One day, I got a call from my brother's girl, letting me know that she thought she saw Tiff in the abortion clinic where she worked. She said she wasn't sure if that was her, so she took a picture and sent it to me. Sure enough, it was Tiff's ass. I asked her, was she with somebody? She told me that Tiff was there to get an abortion, and hearing that shit caused me to black the fuck out. I was gonna kill this bitch, and that was on my mama. I was so pissed I called Nas to let him know what the fuck was going on. By the time I got dressed and got down to the clinic, it was too late. Tiff had already killed my fucking seed. she gave me this long, drawn out speech about her not being ready and her life wasn't right to be bringing a kid into it. I would have respected her more if she told me about it and we made decisions together. She could have had my damn baby and I would have raised my child. I know it's her body and ultimately it would have been her choice, but damn, little mama said, fuck me. That shit was foul as fuck and I just can't rock with her on that. If you woman enough to spread your legs without thought, be woman enough to give life if that ends up being your reality. Cannon, come on, bruh. Wow. Really, nigga? The only reason I didn't fuck her ass up is because of my friendship with her cousins and the fact that Nas pulled up at the clinic the same time I did. Best believe my gun was ready to do some motherfucking damage to her ass. I'm not the type of nigga that's gonna play with your ass when it comes to me and mine. I had to have a drink just thinking about all the shit that went down with her. After I poured my drink, I walked back into the bedroom to get myself together for Nas and Cass's cookout today. Ever since I took over the operation, shit in my life changed for the good. I'm making more money than I've ever seen in my life, and that shit felt good. The way I had shit set up, I barely touched the product or the streets. My team was solid, and my method in this game was A1. My phone was going off, and when I looked at it, I shook my head. I knew I was about to get my ass handed to me. What's up, Mom? I asked her as I placed the call on speaker. Don't what's up me. Why the hell haven't I seen your ass in over a month? If I don't see you by tomorrow, I'm coming over there and fucking you up. I don't know what the fuck is wrong with you and your stupid ass brother. I've been calling y'all for the past week because your sister over here acting like I won't bust her ass down to the white meat, she fussed. My bad, Mom. I'll be over there tomorrow. Do you need anything? I questioned, letting out an exasperated sigh. No, I just need to see my sons and for you to deal with your sister before I break my damn foot off in her ass, she spoke. And I couldn't help but chuckle. My mom and Mercedes were always going through some shit. We're all grown as hell, and my mom still thinks we're babies. Mercedes is 25 years old. My brother Sean is 27, and I'm 29. If it were left up to Brenda Mason, we would all still be living home with her. Okay, I'll come by tomorrow, Ma, and I'll bring Sean with me. We spoke for a few minutes longer and then ended the call. Once I finished getting dressed, I grabbed my keys and headed out the door. Took me about 20 minutes to get to Nas's crib, and I could hear the music coming from the back of the house. I rang the bell, and a few minutes later, Cass opened the door. Hey, bro, come on in, she smiled. What up? How was Paris? I asked, kissing her cheek. I loved it. We were busy with all of the shoots Zoe had, but we found time to have some fun, she smiled. Cass managing Zoe was the move. Her management firm was growing, and Zoe just blew up with modeling, magazines, commercials, and she started her own clothing line. I'm glad you had a good time. Let me go out here and see what's up with your husband, I told her, and walked out back. Nigga, I know your ass out here burning some shit up, I laughed, grabbing me a beer from the cooler. This gonna be the best damn chicken your ass done ate in your life, and this sauce gonna make you run and slap your mama. Wait, not your mama, but it's gonna make you slap another nigga's mama for real, this dumbass nigga said, and we burst out laughing. Who all coming over today, I asked, looking over at him. I wish you stopped asking me that shit every time you come over here. You know damn well she lives in Cali. And if she comes to the city, I would have told you. Bruh, you're going to have to let that shit go, nigga. How the hell can you move on if you still holding on to all that anger? I know the shit was fucked up, and I will feel the same way you do. It's been 2 years, and you got to get right. Nas was right. I needed to let that shit go and forget her ass existed. And that's the end of that chapter. Okay. I like how it started. I don't know. I think it's kind of fucked up that that he called Tiff's name while he was with another girl. Because I'm going to tell you right now, that's a quick way to get a knife plunged into your chest or get your dick cut off. And really, it's up to the bitch you fucking's discretion. So, I don't know, but fucking with me, Swiss cheese, nigga, no God. They said, damn, can we get a hello? They just jumped into the fucking, right? Yeah, they did. They jumped right in. Oh my God, wait a minute. Missouri gonna say, well, I guess we stand. Yeah, I guess we are. I guess we are. Oh my God, today, child. Listen. Okay, let me get this other timestamp because I think I well, first let me see if I missed anybody. Child, listen. No, God. Yes, it is. Okay. Let me see. Hey, sexy buns. Welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. Hey, Peanut. Hey, Jay. Welcome, girl. Thank you for being here. I appreciate you. Karma's in the building. Hey, girl. Hey. Welcome, welcome. I think I got... Oh, nope. I see Naomi. Hey, Naomi. Welcome. Happy hump day to you. Thank you for being here. I appreciate you. So, Erkin Jerk said, I bet she didn't have an abortion. I bet she got that baby out in California with her. You think so? Maybe the girl was wrong. Because, like, how the fuck would Tiff get pregnant? I mean, didn't they use a condom every time they was together? I thought they did. Somebody run the footages back so we can see. Oh, my God. I thought they did. I think he was always, you know, covered up in saran wrap and hefty condoms. Because, child, listen, that's what you need now. You need a fucking steel-belted radio rubber-ass condom. Because, child, oh, my God. Mm-mm. You don't know what these fools got inside their bodies and shit. All right, so I got my time stamp. Just a little quick little countdown, child. Oh, my God. Chapter 2, Tiff. Damn, mumble mouth ass. I got too excited. Does Nas and Priest know you're home? Brittany asked as we got in the car. No, I wanted to surprise them. Oh, they ass gonna be surprised, all right. Brittany wasn't helping the situation at all. I was already nervous about how my cousins were gonna react when they saw me. I haven't talked to them as much in the past year. Nas felt the need to keep talking shit to me about what I had done to Cannon. I made decisions that I would regret for the rest of my life, and I feel fucked up about it. At the time, I was so lost, I wasn't ready to be a mother, and I didn't want to bring a baby into the crazy shit I had going on. I got so much grief from my family, it kind of pushed me away. Certain things that were happening in my life, I kept to myself. I was hurt about how they treated me. When Nas called and told me he and Cass were getting married, it took a lot for me to get on that plane and go to their wedding. I knew Cannon would be there, and I knew they would bring up what happened between us, and I was right. Once I got back to Cali, I didn't call as much. They looked down on me and didn't want to hear shit I had to say other than that I was wrong. The look on Cannon's face when he came into that abortion clinic would forever be etched into my memory. Since I moved to California with Brittany, my life has changed in so many ways. Being with Cannon opened up something in me. I bet the fuck it did. Anyway, it changed me and the way I was living my life. I no longer wanted to be in a relationship with a woman. My desire to be with a man outweighed my desire to be with a woman. I guess I have Cannon to thank for that. Cannon and his Cannon is who you're thanking, child. Anyway, I tried reaching out to him so many times to apologize, but he wanted nothing to do with me. Eventually, I respected his wish and moved on with my life. What did Marlo say about you coming to Philadelphia? Brittany asked. He didn't like it, so he's flying out tomorrow. I looked over at her as I turned onto Nas's street. Marlo and I met a few months after I moved to Cali, and I've been with him for almost 2 years now. We got engaged about 6 months ago. Pause. Bitch, what? Hello, so we 2 years later? This 2 years later now? Listen, okay. Whatever. So they got engaged 6 months ago, and we have a beautiful daughter, Anaya, that's 4 months old. Oh, my gosh. She got a baby, y'all, with another nigga. All right, so are we done with this book, or we keep on keeping on? Y'all tell me while I wet my whistle. I'm away. Come on, Tiff. Y'all know this about to be some shit, right? Damn. Wait a minute. Said gonna say, Saki, since you extra long stroked us, I forgot if they used a condom. It was feeling that good you couldn't tell if a condom was on or not, said. Oh, my God. Yes. Who now? A baby. Naomi a baby. Yeah. Okay, Cupcake said, keep going. Shit. All right. Oh, my God. That nigga better not come here acting like he some hard-ass nigga. Your cousin's gonna humble his ass real quick. To be honest, I don't think it's the best time to introduce him to them, especially with his controlling over-the-top ass. Brittany couldn't stand Marlo because she felt like he was too controlling and was trying to stop me from being friends with her. Brittany is my best friend. Marlo could never come between that, and he knew it. I pulled up in front of Nas's house. There were a lot of cars here. We got out of the car, and Brittany helped me with Anaya. Girl, I can't wait to see their damn face when they find out you had a baby, Brittany said as we rang the doorbell. It took a few minutes for someone to open the door. Tiff, what the hell? When did you come in town? And who baby you got? Britt, you had a baby? Nas questioned with a confused look on his face. Hell no, I don't believe in pushing nothing up out this cat here. I got a virgin uterus and we gonna keep that shit that way, Britt blurted out. Nas, this is my daughter, Anaya, I said to him. Mm-mm, nah, we not doing this today. This was supposed to be a good day, and I live in a good damn neighborhood. I'm cool with the neighborhood captain, and I don't got time for the shit that's about to take place if you bring your ass up in here. The Grim Reaper is here, and his ass been killing niggas left and right for the last 2 years. Half the niggas he killed still asking why they the fuck dead. I would hate to see you be his next victim. This ain't it right now. Come back later when everybody gone, he said, and slammed the door. Wait a minute. This nigga slammed the door. Y'all know Nas ain't got no goddamn sense. Oh, my God. He said the Grim Reaper's here, nigga. Oh, my God. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Oh, Lord, okay. Oh, my God. I couldn't believe he did that shit. Brittany was bent over laughing so damn hard she was choking. Let's go. I think he means Cannon is here. I'm not ready to see him right now, and this isn't the best time for him to see my baby. Just as I turned to walk away, I heard Cass screaming, oh, my God. Tiff, when did you get in town? Y'all come in. Don't pay no attention to Nas's dramatic ass, she yelled. I don't think this is a good idea, Cass, I told her. Why not? We haven't seen you in over a year. I should beat your ass for not calling me like you should. Oh, whose baby? She questioned. This is my daughter, Anaya. I looked at her. What? You had a baby? Congrats, sis. Come on in. Oh, shit. We're having a cookout and Cannon is here, she said. Maybe you should take your ass upstairs until we can figure out how to get his ass out of here. Cass, if you're letting her in the house, let me go get my damn gun first. I may have to shoot this angry nigga in the kneecaps because I damn sure won't be fighting his angry husky ass, Nas yelled out from the door. Damn, that nigga still mad? I'll keep Naya with me and you two niggas can fight this shit on out, Brittany's dumb ass laughed. Bitch, you hold on to your baby. He won't touch you with her in your hand. Other than that, your ass might get it. Nas is right. Cannon has been on one since all that shit went down with you. But you can't run from him forever, and we're family. Your cousin is crazy as hell, and he may come down hard on you. I know for sure he would never let anything happen to you. To be honest, I think Cannon still loves you. And what you did hurt him. I don't think he'll hurt you, though. Let's go inside. Zoe is going to go crazy when she sees you. Cass attempted to grab the baby and thought about it. Right, she was going to take the baby, but girl, you better hold that damn baby. Brittany burst out laughing again, and we walked inside. I'm not sure if this was the best decision. I should have just left and come back later. I didn't want to hurt him any more than I already have. No one was inside the house. Everybody was out back, which gave me time to get myself together. Had I known they were having a cookout, I would have come by another time. I'm going to go scope out everything and let you know if it's safe to come out, Brittany shrugged and walked out back. I could hear Zoe scream because she knew if Brittany was here, then so was I. A few minutes later, Britt came running back in the house with Zoe behind her like they had fire attached to their ass. Get your shit, sis. Nas was right. This ain't it. Nas and Priest were talking to him, and that nigga straight turned into the Incredible Hulk. I don't think this is the time for you to be seeing him right now. As a matter of fact, I think you should just forget you ever knew that nigga, Britt said, as she grabbed Naya's bag and pulled me to the door. As much as I want to catch up right now, Brittany's right. he is pissed, and I swear I would hate to cut his ass over you. Tiff, she's beautiful. I'm mad as hell that you didn't tell us, Zoe said, hugging me. I'm sorry. I know I have a lot of explaining to do. Just as I said that, Cannon came inside the house with Nas and Priest behind him. This is what the fuck you do? You go have a baby by the next nigga, but kill my fucking seed? Bitch, you ain't shit. Don't ever in your motherfucking life say shit to me again. Look, I know you mad, but you're not gonna stand here and disrespect me. I'm sorry, and if I can go back in time, I wouldn't have done that. I don't regret having my daughter, and you're not gonna make me feel bad for having her and bringing her around my family, I cried, because at this point, I was pissed the fuck off. Wiping my eyes, I began patting Naya's back because she started crying. Oh my God, Tiff, you're married, Zoe yelled out, and I forgot all about my engagement ring on my finger. What the fuck? Cannon roared, punching a hole in the wall. Bruh, I'm sorry, wait a minute. Punching a hole in the wall? I know you lying. No, sir. No, sir, and no, ma'am. You do not punch holes in my wall because you pissed at somebody else. This ain't her shit. Go to Cali, go in her shit, and punch a hole in her shit. Not mine. The fuck? Hey, Jewel Cray, welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. And you too, Fancy Danny. I appreciate y'all. Welcome. Right. Oh, incredible Hulk face ass. Right. Oh, Hulk smash head ass nigga. Get your ass out of here. Tear shit up. Nigga, I know damn well you ain't punch up my shit. I'm gonna give you this one. But when you calm your overly hyper ass down, you gonna fix my shit. Now, I know shit is fucked up right now, but y'all gonna have to talk this shit out. You my bro, and I know you pissed. Just keep in mind that she's my cousin, Nas said to me. And he just, wait a minute. Yeah, Nas said to him, sorry. And he just walked out without saying shit to anyone. I had to cast the baby, and I ran outside to try and talk to him. Tiff, come back in here and talk to that nigga through the window, I heard Nas yell out. Cannon, please wait, I called out. Nah, I'm good on you, little mama. Just stay the fuck away from me. He jumped in his car and sped out of the driveway. My heart felt like it was gonna burst out of my chest. I never meant to hurt him this badly, and I don't know how to make it right. I love my fiance and want him to meet my family, but Brittany was right. I don't think it's a good time for Marlo to come here. And that's the end of that chapter. Child, listen. Oh my God. This is crazy, y'all. And this is two books. So I wonder if he get her back in this book, or is we got to deal with the song and dance, the tap dancing and the hip swinging before they get, that was the end of that chapter in case I didn't say it, before they get back together. Cause child, listen, Lord have mercy. I don't know about this thing, y'all. We gonna see. Let me, I got my time stamp. We just gotta let it count down. Ooh, Lord. All right. Chapter 3, Nas. I can't believe this emotional ass nigga put a hole in my damn wall. Just call someone and get it fixed, babe, Cass said. Hell no, I'm not fixing that shit. When that nigga get right, he gonna bring his ass over here and patch my shit up. I knew we shouldn't have let Tiff ass in here until we got rid of that nigga. I can't believe she got married and didn't tell us, Zoe said. I didn't get married, I'm engaged, Tiff said, walking back into the room. Man, you need to sit your ass down and get to explaining. How did you get this baby? Did you go to one of them baby places and they put one in you? She had my ass confused as hell. I'm engaged to my daughter's father. I'm not confused. I know what I want, and I'm in a happy place right now. I know what I did to Cannon was wrong, and I'm sorry about it. I tried apologizing to him, and he wouldn't hear me out. He wanted nothing to do with me, so I moved on with my life. I regret what I did, but I can't stop living. I do want to be in a good space with my family. It seems that you all turned against me for the decisions I made back then, she cried, and I felt fucked up about it. I didn't mean to make you feel that way. I wasn't feeling your decision, but I would never turn my back on you, Tiff. We gonna always be family, and that trumps everything and everybody. Now get your confused ass over here and give me a hug. We all burst out laughing. Yeah, no matter what the circumstances are, we got you, Priest said, pulling her in for a hug. What's up with this dude you about to marry? I asked her. His name is Marlo. He'll be here tomorrow. I want y'all to meet him, so maybe we can all hang out at the club tomorrow night, she asked. Ooh, this about to be a mess, Brittany mumbled, and I caught that shit. Yeah, we can do that, I told her. Tiff, she is so beautiful, Zoe said, taking the baby from Cass. Thank you. I love her entire existence. I never knew I could love unconditionally until I held her in my arms. What y'all got to eat in here? I'm hungry, she smiled, walking into the kitchen. I see that shit ain't changed about your greedy ass. We all burst out laughing. For the rest of the night, we got caught up on everything that was happening with all of us. And then there's a break in the chapter. Oh, Lord. Right, Missouri. Zoe didn't have to say shit. Just assume she married and talk to her later. But remember, they're excited to see her. So they don't know, you know, like they can't, they're not thinking. They just expressing how they feel, even though it is making the situation cringy as fuck. Oh my God. All right. I was on my way over to check on Cannon. I knew he was still feeling some type of way about him and Tiff. I just didn't know the shit was still fucking with him like that. I rang the doorbell waiting for him to open the door. Sup? He allowed me in and we walked into his family room. I wanted to come check on you. Shit was crazy yesterday. Bro, I ain't know she was coming home and I damn sure didn't know she had a baby. The look this nigga gave me let me know that maybe I should just shut the fuck up. I can't even tell you what's going through my head right now. I mean, this girl killed my baby just to go get pregnant by another nigga and have his kid. And then she goes and marries the nigga? That shit got me ready to murder a nigga, he roared. Bruh, she's not married yet. And before she does get married, I think you two should talk. You need to get some shit off your chest and either close the book or open that motherfucker back up. Because you clearly still love her. A blind man can see that shit. I shrugged, getting up to go pour me a drink from the bar. I don't love shit. I know that's your cousin, so it's best that we stop talking about the shit. I'm good on her and anything about her ass. Keep that shit to yourself. Our shipment is coming in, and I'm about to head out and make sure everything is good. Did the repairman come through and fix your wall? Yeah, nigga. Next time, tear your own shit up. Don't bring your angry ass over to my crib fucking up my good shit. You can say what you want, but I know you feeling something for my cousin with your mad ass. I'm glad we had this talk. I'ma head out and get shit ready for the at the club for tonight. Oh yeah, I guess I'll keep that her nigga is here and they gonna be at the club tonight to myself since your mad ass don't give a damn. Thought maybe you wanted to come scope out your competition because this shit with you and Tiff ain't over. I dapped this angry bird looking ass up and left out. Not his angry bird. Oh my God, Nas is so fucking ignorant. By the time I made it back home, it was almost 9. Babe, I'm riding with you to the club tonight. I want to get my drink on and I can't do that if I have to drive. I'm just going to catch a ride home with Zoe and Priest if you're going to close up tonight. Cass walked by, kissing my lips. Nah, I'm not closing. We supposed to be hanging out with Tiff and her dude. I can't believe her ass done had a baby and talking about marrying that nigga. I don't like dude already. Her ass supposed to be with Cannon. I know she fucked up. I just think it's still some hope for them. Cannon can say what he wants, but I know what it is with him. Nas, you haven't met the guy yet, she laughed. Cass, I don't like him, and your ass better not like him neither. We team Cannon over here. Fuck dude. I shrugged, putting my shoes on so we could leave. Damn right. Fuck dude. So, we gonna help them rekindle and pray he can forgive her for what she did to him. Operation Get Tiff and Cannon Back Together is in full effect, she smiled. And I had to press pause on her ass. Mm-mm, hell no. I'm not playing no damn matchmaker and shit. The last time we did that shit, that took all my energy. And I had to practice my lines just so the shit would come out right. And Cannon is a different type of damn animal than Priest was. This nigga is a walking time bomb. Anything can set him off at this point. I did put a bug in his ear about tonight, though. I doubt he comes since he ain't fucking with Tiff, I told her. What? What if he decides to come? She questioned. That nigga ain't coming. Now bring your fine ass on. Since our son is with your mom, I'ma tear your ass up when we get back home tonight. Cass's mom took us up on our offer, so I built her a 2-bedroom guest house out back, and she loves it. I bet the fuck she do, hell. Everything free. This bitch whole lifestyle free. We love having her here to help us out with our son. And the best part is she cooks for my ass every day. It says every day, y'all, I promise. I got that good for you, Zaddy. We're going to be swinging from the ceiling tonight. I looked over at her crazy ass and burst out laughing. About 30 minutes later, we were walking into the VIP section of my club. Tiff, Brittany, and I guess the dude they were talking to was her fiance, were sitting at the bar. "What's up?" I greeted, walking up to him. "Hey, cousin, where is Zoe and Priest?" Tiff asked as she stood hugging Cass and me. "I thought he would be here by now," I said to her, looking in the direction of the dude sitting with him. "Nas, Cass, this is my fiance, Marlo. Bae, this is my cousin Nas and his wife, Cass," Tiff introduced us. "Sup, nice spot you have here," Marlo spoke as he dapped me up. "Appreciate that, man. Hey, Shayna, drinks on the house for them," I yelled over the music to my barmaid as Cass and I took a seat at the bar. "Go Crazy" by Chris Brown came blaring through the speakers and the ladies jumped up dancing and acting crazy like old times. "Tiff, you good? Sit down." Marlo grabbed her arm and pulled her back in her seat. My bitch nigga monitor instantly went off with his ass. "Damn, I'm just trying to chill and have a good time with my family. I'm not about to be sitting here in a chair all night babysitting you," Tiff bellowed, and she got back up to dance with the girls while this nigga had his face all balled the fuck up. A few minutes later, Priest and Zoe came walking in and greeted us. "About time y'all got here," I told them. "We all know how my wife is when she's getting dressed," Priest acknowledged, smiling over at Zoe. "Whatever," Zoe laughed, nudging him. "Yo, you the modeling chick, right? I see you on TV and in magazines," Marlo said to Zoe, which caused Priest to turn to him quick as hell. "You better tread softly fucking with that nigga and his wife." "Priest, Zoe, this is my fiance, Marlo," Tiff introduced. "Bae, look," Cass whispered in my ear, nudging the hell out of my arm. Looking at what she was looking at caused me to shake my damn head. I knew tonight was getting ready to be a motherfucking massacre when Cannon and his brother Sean stepped into the VIP. And that's the end of that chapter. Listen, he might as well burn that fucking club down and say that it was vandalized because they about to tear shit up in there. Oh my God. Why did Cannon come when he said he wasn't coming? Oh my God. He said he didn't want nothing to do with her. Why are you there? Why are you there? He's so fucking petty, yo. I can't stand Cannon. What the why niggas do shit like that? Oh my God. This is insane, right? She talking about dun dun dun, right? Chapter 4, Cannon. Finding out Tiff had a baby fucked me up, but I'm the type of nigga that don't let shit die easily. The fact that she felt the need to bring this nigga to my city didn't sit well with me. I always come to the club on the weekends and that shit ain't gonna stop now because she got her nigga with her. Bruh, if this nigga gets sideways, just know I'm knocking his head off and he can pick that shit up and take it back to Cali with him, Sean spoke. It seems that all eyes were on me and Tiff ass looked like her ass was ready to make a run for it. "Not if I do that shit first," I said to him as we approached the bar. "What's up?" I dapped Nas and Priest up and hugged all of the ladies except Tiff. "Shayna, let me get my usual and send it over to the section." There was no way that I was going to sit at the bar. "How you been, Cannon?" Britt asked. "I'm good. What about you?" I looked over at her. "Bro, I'm going over to the section," Sean stated as Britt looked him up and down. "Damn, they making y'all Philly niggas finer and finer every time I come here. Maybe I need to move my ass back to indulge," Britt smiled at him. "You don't want to climb this tree, little mama. I'm not your typical nigga. I'll fuck the shit out of you without thinking twice, and your ass will definitely be moving back to Philly." He winked at her and walked off. I had to laugh because Britt needs to think about her next move and make it her best move fucking with that crazy nigga. I decided to be a messy nigga and speak to Tiff. "What's up, Tiff?" She looked at me in surprise, knowing I didn't fuck with her. "Hey, Cannon, this is..." I cut her off. "I'm good, little mama. I'm not interested in knowing who this nigga is. I just didn't want to be rude and not speak to you," I smirked at her. "Aw, hell. Y'all be ready for whatever at this point." Nas was right. They needed to get ready because I was on one and this nigga could get it. Period. But I'm here for it. Talk your shit, Cannon, Britt spat. And remember, Britt, that was Britt saying period. And she don't like Marlo, right? So she like, "I'm here for it. Talk your shit." Tiff rolled her eyes at her. "Bruh, when you talking to my girl, you gonna know me," her bitch made nigga said. I knew I was in the wrong, but who gives a fuck? I said what the fuck I said. I say what I want and do what I want. The only person I need to know is her, and I clearly know her from the inside out, I smirked. "My nigga," Nas blurted out. Cannon, don't do that. I could tell that Tiff was nervous, so I let the shit go and turned to leave. That is, until the next thing that came out this nigga mouth halted my steps. So that's the nigga you was fucking and killed his kid? Obviously, the pussy still got an issue, but I'm gonna solve that motherfucker for him. Get your shit and let's go. Got me in here going back and forth with this bitch-ass nigga. She killed your kid because she was waiting on me, nigga. That shit had me on this nigga before he could blink. I tried to rip this nigga's motherfucking head off. What the fuck you say, bitch? I roared, punching his ass over and over again. He was trying to get his shit off, but I had erupted and there was no match for the shit I was giving this pussy. I could hear the screaming and yelling, but my ass was zoned out, and all I wanted was this nigga in a body bag. Security tried to pull me off of him. I wasn't having it. No, don't nobody touch him. That nigga deserved this motherfucking beatdown. He could have said anything else but that bullshit, Nas roared. Cannon, stop it. You're gonna kill him, Tiff screamed. And that was exactly what I was trying to do. Kill his ass. Come on, bro, I heard Nas say as they pulled me off him. The nigga was still on the floor when my brother kicked him in his shit. Security helped Tiff get his pussy ass off the floor and took him out of the club. I swear that nigga was lucky they were still holding me down. Fuck, I roared. You good? Priest asked. Man, I'm ready to kill that nigga. I know she got a baby by him, and I know I started the shit, but I'm ready to murder that nigga. Yeah, that was fucked up, Priest stated, just as Nas came walking up. Come outside with me for a minute, he said, and I followed him out. When we made it outside, we heard yelling coming from the parking lot. You think that shit cute? You out here taking up for this nigga, the guy yelled. Your ass was wrong. You knew that situation was sensitive for both of us. Yet when you realized who he was, you threw the shit in his face. Yeah, he said some crazy shit to you. You could have just kept that shit gutter and talked your shit. What you said was fucked up, and you know it. The fuck? Tiff yelled. I knew that voice from anywhere. Bitch, I will break your fucking jaw out here. I'm the only nigga you gonna go hard for, he told her. And Nas and I were already walking up on him. No, you not talking to my cousin like that, bruh. I'll murder your ass and send you back to your mama in a pine fucking box. We don't play them type games. Now, y'all can handle your personal business, but if you put your hands on her, I'm coming for you. You a foul ass nigga for what the fuck you said, and you deserved what the fuck you got. If you feel like you need to get some of that motherfucking aggression off of you, I can give you what you're looking for. I can't stand niggas like you. Tiff, I don't like your dude, and that's that on that, Nas said to them. Nigga, fuck you. Before Nas could react, I was punching that nigga in his fucking jaw again. When I said every time I see his ass, I meant that shit. Security came running over and pulled me off of him, and Tiff was standing there in tears. Tiff, you good? Nas asked her as they pulled me away. Yeah, I'm sorry about all of this. It was supposed to be a fun night, she spoke, wiping her tears away. I was ready to explode in this parking lot. I had to get the fuck out of here. The rest of the crew was already outside. Bro, let's ride, I told my brother. Lil Mama, you coming with me? Sean asked Britt, and she nodded that she was. Tiff, I'm going with Sean. I'll see you tomorrow, Brittany said to her. Brittany, old turncoat ass. She like, shit, it's dick on deck, bitch. Bye. You going over there with Marlo, beat up bitch ass. I'm going over here with a dick at, bitch. Sorry. All right. Walking to the car, I couldn't stop the rage inside of me. That shit was boiling over, and there wasn't a damn thing nobody could do about it. I had so many unanswered questions, and at this point, I ain't give a damn who that nigga was to her. I turned, walking back over to where they all were standing. I picked Tiff's ass up, placing her over my shoulders, and walked back to my car. Cannon, put me fucking down. Are you crazy? She screamed. Last time you told me to put you down, you landed on my dick. Tonight is no fucking different. Yo, that nigga is a straight up savage nigga. You just gonna let him take your girl like that? I heard Nas yell out. Bro, I need you to drive my car and drop me off home. I threw him the keys and put her in the car. She was still going off trying to get her ass out. She was coming with me, and I ain't give a fuck about her doing all that damn screaming. We all hopped in, and Sean pulled off, headed to my crib. And that's the end of that chapter. Well, now, that's how you make an exit. You just pick your bitch up and walk off. Fuck her man. Fuck her man standing there. You pick her up and you walk off with her. Lord have mercy. All right, let me get this time stamp. Yo, I don't even know what the hell I just read. How you just, they done beat this nigga ass inside the club, outside the club. I wonder if he be putting his hands on Tiff, but Tiff beat bitches up. So I know that she ain't sitting up there in an abusive ass relationship. Like, oh my God. Like, this is crazy. I hope she wouldn't do that. I know she wouldn't do that. Y'all think she would do that? Hell no, that girl wouldn't do that. She wouldn't be in no damn abusive relationship. That's crazy. Oh, Lord. Oh, wait a minute. Peanut said, got me scratching my head looking for the blunt. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. No, 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 no. Child, listen. Don't scratch your head looking for the blunt. Child, listen. Yeah, he felt a little froggy. He sure the fuck did. He felt a little froggy. Yep. I knew what you meant. I knew exactly what you meant. Yeah, he may be putting his hands on her. That's what I'm thinking. But she don't seem like the type that'll go for that type of bullshit. Not without telling her cousins. We'll see. Chapter 5, Tiff. I can't believe that he just did that shit. How the fuck am I going to explain being snatched up by the next nigga? As soon as I saw Cannon walking into the club, I knew it was going to be some shit. I'm pissed the hell off that Marlo did that shit, but Cannon is so fucking wrong right now. About 20 minutes later, we were pulling in front of a house that I've never seen before, so I assumed that Cannon moved. Let's go, he looked over at me. Cannon, I'm not going inside. I have a fiance, and this shit is fucking disrespectful, I argued. You going in one or two ways. You can walk in or I'll carry you in. He got out of the car, walked to my side, and opened the door. Bye, sis. Make sure that nigga hit it from all angles, Britt yelled out, and I wanted to slap the shit out of her ass. The next thing I knew, I was being lifted out of the seat. As soon as he closed the door, Sean backed out of the driveway. He carried me inside, walking upstairs to his bedroom and placing me on my feet. Why did you do that shit? Marlo is going to lose his damn mind, I snapped, as soon as he put me down. He just stared at me with this look that made me nervous as hell. Do me a favor. Don't speak on that nigga when you with me. I poured my fucking soul out to you, and you go do some fuck shit by killing my fucking baby. Why ain't you come to me, Tiff? Why would you go and do some shit like that and then come back here like shit is all good with another nigga's baby? You don't see anything wrong with that shit? He roared. His eyes were bloodshot red and he was damn near foaming at the mouth. The way he was looking at me made me feel like total shit and I couldn't stop the tears from flowing down my face. Cannon, I'm so sorry. It was such a bad mistake and I'll have to live with that for the rest of my life. I never meant to hurt you and it was selfish of me to make that decision on my own. No, it's not. Your body, your choice. The fuck? Because women who have babies that they don't want are at risk of abusing those children. The fuck out of here. I promise you, if I could go back in time, I wouldn't have done that. Back then, I was going through so much that you didn't know about, and I wasn't in a good space to have a baby. Don't give me that bullshit excuse. I would have taken my fucking kid, he yelled, as tears began to fill the rim of his eyes. I stepped closer to him, placing my hand on his face. I'm sorry. I don't know what else to do or say to make this situation better. I can't be here with you. I'm engaged to someone else, I whispered. I truly didn't want to have an attitude with him, nor did I want to make matters worse. I know things were different with us, but I still wanted to have some type of closure with him. So you really love this nigga? He asked, never breaking his stare. Yes, I love him. He chuckled, and the way he was watching me let me know that my answer triggered some shit in him. I almost felt like I needed to get the fuck out of here. Fuck that. I know I need to get the fuck out of here. Just as the thought crossed my mind, he pulled me closer to him, crashing his lips onto mine. Pause. No, sir. No. Nah. Come on, man. You don't know where this girl been. What she been doing? Come on, Cannon, man. I thought you was getting ready to have a conversation with her. Not trying to... I mean, I get that you are emotional and shit, but I... Yeah, nah. This that bullshit. Because fucking ain't gonna fix none of this. Sir. No. And you know what, wifey? That's probably what... Oh, my God. Y'all ain't say shit as we blew past chapter 3. Nothing. Oh, Lord, here we go. I tried to push him back, but the way he was sucking on my bottom lip had my ass stuck and my whole ass pussy twitching like the bitch was fighting an addiction. I couldn't hold it. I have missed this man and yearned for him for so fucking long. Then why are you engaged to somebody else, ma'am? We were so fucking hungry, clothes were being ripped apart, and when his tongue touched my body, I was on fire. He skillfully sucked and licked from my neck to my breast, sliding his finger onto my pussy as he massaged my clit. A moan escaped my mouth, and that was all he needed to hear. He lifted me in the air like I was a sheet of paper, placing me on top of his dresser. When he turned the soundbar on, again by DVSN featuring Chantel came on, and my heart felt like it was gonna explode. Fuck you wet, he growled in my ear. Cannon, please, I called out. I felt like my breath got caught in my throat when he slammed his big ass dick inside of me without warning. Is this what you want? Because I got 2 years of reserve fucking to get off my motherfucking chest. The more he talked his shit, the wetter I got. His thrust became deeper and deeper, and I was doing my best to keep up. His thrust was so powerful, it brought tears to my eyes. It was like we were both fighting to be in this moment, and it still wasn't enough. I knew all of this shit was wrong, but there was no way that I could stop. God damn, this pussy is a motherfucker. He slammed into me over and over again, pounding on my G-spot. I have never been fucked this hard and good in my damn life. I was losing it, and there was nothing I could do about it as cum began pouring out of me. Oh, fuck, Cannon. Fuck this pussy. Harder, I screamed. Fuck, give me that shit, little mama, because, fuck, he roared as I clamped down on his dick and started throwing and grinding my pussy on his ass. He pulled out of me and flipped me over, entering me from behind and fucking my life up. I don't remember this nigga dick being this damn good. He was fucking me so damn hard, I could feel that shit in my chest, and he had my ass running. Oh my God, I screamed as I tried to get him to ease up a little. Stop fucking running and take this motherfucker. Talking about you love that nigga. Your pussy is wrapped around my dick. You gonna love this dick and everything that comes with that shit, he gritted as he gripped my ass, thrusting into me so damn deep I couldn't even respond to what he was saying. This shit felt good as hell, but it also felt like he was giving me bitch, I'm fuck your ass up strokes. Pulling out of me, he sat down on the bed and pulled me on top of him. Ah, shit, I moaned as I eased down on him. Damn, this pussy is a fucking beast, he gritted, slamming me down on his dick, fucking the shit out of me. I tried to keep up, but this nigga was just too much for me to handle. Shit, I can't hold it. Oh, God, I'm coming, I screamed as I began squirting all on his dick. That's what the fuck I'm talking about. I love a sloppy wet pussy. Oh, fuck, he growled, gripping my ass cheeks as he came with me. We just laid there in our thoughts until he eased out of me and got out of bed. Get cleaned up and I'll take you back to your man. As soon as the shit rolled off his tongue, I felt like shit. A couple of hours later, he dropped me off in front of my mother's house. I'll call you later. He nodded and I got out of the car. My rental car was in the driveway and I knew it was going to be some shit. Taking a deep breath, I rang the doorbell because I didn't have my key or phone to call my mom. When Cannon snatched me up, I had already put my purse in the car. My mom opened the door, shaking her head. Girl, what in the flying fuck did you get yourself into? This crazy looking nigga been walking around here acting like a plum fool, talking to himself and shit. You know I don't do crazy. And who the fuck beat his ass black and blue and took your ass? Cannon, Lord, I see why there was nothing he could do to stop it. Done let Cannon's fine ass come in and just take his girl in his face. That's some hard shit right there. That's the kind of nigga I need. Just come in and take what you want, she laughed, shaking her head. Ma, where's Anaya? I wanted to make sure my baby was good. She's in my room asleep for now. I told his ass if he keep doing all that damn yelling, he would be on the other side of the door, she spoke, just as Marlo walked into the living room. You think this shit sweet? I got something for that nigga. You just gonna ride off with that nigga and leave me in a fucking parking lot? I'm gonna see that nigga. This shit is not over. It's damn near 6 a.m. and you walking in here like you weren't with another nigga. Did you fuck him? He roared, looking like a madman, gripping me by the neck and pushing me up against the wall. whap. I slapped the shit out of his ass for putting his hands on me. He has a right to be mad, but no, I'm the wrong bitch to be putting his hands on. Don't get fucked up in here. Make that the last time you touch me. You can say what the fuck you have to say without putting your hands on me. This nigga had me pissed the hell off. Nigga, you done lost all the mind the devil gave your ass. If you ever put your hands on my child again, I promise you that's gonna be the last time you use that bitch, my mom told him. Pack your shit. We going home, he stated, ignoring what my mom said, but he damn sure stepped away from me. I'm here visiting my mom for a week. I'm not leaving just because you and your feelings. I didn't ask you to come here. You came because you wanted to control my every move, I told him. What I don't understand is how you let another nigga walk off with your fiance. That just don't sit right with me. My mom was not helping this situation at all with her crazy ass. Mom, I'm good. Why don't you go back to bed, I said to her. When she left the room, I walked upstairs to my bedroom with Marlo still going off behind me. Tiff, you didn't answer my fucking question. Did you fuck him? He looked over at me. I ain't want to lie to him, but there was no way that I could tell him that Cannon had his big, beautiful fucking dick so far up in me. I could feel that shit lodged in my throat. And the fucked up thing is all I could think about is him right now. Visions of him sliding in and out of me were taking over and had my pussy pulsating. Fuck, this shit could not be happening to me right now. Answer my damn question, he yelled, jolting me out of my thoughts. No, I blurted out and walked into the bathroom. Pause. Is that no, you not answering his question, or no, you didn't fuck him? That's me talking, y'all. Because see, that no could mean any fucking thing. Because she said she didn't want to lie to him. So what did the fucking no mean? That's what I need to know. What the fuck did the no mean? Tiff, I'm not playing. We going back to Cali as soon as I can get us a flight. I knew he was serious about going home. I'm just not going with him. I told you I'm not leaving. It's been a year since I've seen my family, and my mom is bonding with her granddaughter. If you want to go, you can. Just know that I'm staying. I'm sorry this happened, Marlo. I think you should calm down and let's enjoy our time here. You won't have to worry about my cousins or Cannon anymore. One more thing. Don't ever make the mistake of putting your hands on me again. I wanted him to know that I'm not playing no games with his ass. He got a problem if he thinks we gonna be on that type of time. I'm not worried about them niggas. They gonna see me about this shit. My bad for doing that shit to you. You know how I get when I feel disrespected. I have to leave in a couple of days anyway, so I'll stay until then. I need some pussy. It's been a long night. I had to think fast because I couldn't fuck him. I told you yesterday that I was cramping. My cycle came on. Marlo, I think it's best that you leave it alone when dealing with my cousins. I know you in the streets and got your crew, but don't start a war with my family. I won't let you hurt them, and I'm not gonna let them hurt you. You all were wrong for disrespecting each other, and I plan on talking to them about it. I'm begging you to just leave the shit alone. Have you seen my purse? I need to get my phone out of it. I had to try and change the subject quickly. I hear you. Your purse is in the car. I'm going to bed. I'm tired as hell, he said, and I was so thankful that he was dropping this shit for now. I knew he was mad, but at least he calmed down. Walking out of my room, I went out to the car and grabbed my purse. My phone had a few missed calls from Cass and Nas, and I had a text message from a number I didn't recognize. And it says, unknown. You better not fuck that nigga. I don't give a damn what he is to you. And she texted back, who the fuck is this? And they text back, stop fucking playing with me. Oh my God, how did Cannon get my damn number? I thought, I'm gonna fuck Brittany up. I know she gave him my shit. What the hell have I gotten myself into? And that's the end of that chapter. Child, listen. Oh, shit. Oh my God. Hey. Oh man, y'all. I am tripping right now. Now here he talking about some, I need some pussy. Nope. What you need is Fistina and Palmina, sir. With a little bit of suave lotion. Because I don't know what to tell you, Pimptastic. Mm-mm. You better roll over and choke that chick until it starts squawking. Because I wouldn't even be able to feel you in there. Because I just had a cannon up in me. Sorry, Tiny Tim, Mini Marlo. Good night, nigga. Shit. Roll your thimble dick ass over and go to sleep, nigga. Oh my God, I am so fucking ignorant. All right, let me get my time stamp. Oh my God, I done hurt that nigga feelings. Trust me, sir, you don't want to go in there after Cannon. You don't want to do that. That shit gonna hurt your soul, sir. Don't do that shit. You gonna hurt your own damn feelings, nigga. Because I ain't gonna say shit. You gonna feel what I mean. Or not. Ah, shit. Lord have mercy. All right. Chapter 6. Brittany. I'm being the biggest hoe right now, and I'm loving every minute of my wholeness. The shit that got me screaming inside is the way Cannon beat the brakes off Marlowe's ass. Ooh, baby, I've been waiting on this day to come ever since I met his pussy ass. I can't stand Marlowe's ass. That nigga ain't shit. I tried to tell Tiff the nigga was full of shit. I've caught that nigga staring at me plenty of times. I don't want to start no shit with my best friend and having her think that I want her man. You good? Sean asked, walking into the bedroom with his dick swinging. I'm tired as hell, but I'm definitely good. I smiled at him when he climbed back into bed. This nigga fucked me so good, my fucking uterus was clapping. What? Her uterus was clapping like, bravo, bravo. Oh, Lord. I needed to be dick down. It's been 2 months since I had some damn dick. I have never gone that long without having sex. So getting with this sexy ass man was much needed. And I don't even care that I just met his ass, because, Lord, this nigga is fine. His tannish brown complexion, brown eyes, tattoos, and oh my God, the muscles on his ass just set everything off about him. He had the prettiest set of white teeth, and his hair was faded around the sides with a curly coiled fro. God bless they mama, because she did her thing when she had them. Cannon was even finer than his damn brother, and Marlowe's ass can't even compare. His ass can't even sit at the table with Cannon on his bad day. Nah. Ain't no sleep going on in here, shorty. You talked all that shit. Now we gonna fuck until I pull all that cum out of you. When it comes to some good pussy, I don't get tired. That shit fuels me. He pulled me on top of him, sliding his fingers over my clit, causing my pussy to jump. Fuck, I moaned as I ground my pussy on his fingers. Damn, girl, you wet as fuck, he said, grabbing a condom from the nightstand and moving me a little to the side so he could sheath his dick. Get on that motherfucking ride, that shit, he spoke, as my cell phone started going off on his nightstand. I glanced at it, and this nigga picked it up to answer it. You worry about riding my dick, and I'm gonna worry about this nigga Trey that's calling you early in the fucking morning. Yo, what up? He spoke into the phone, and I was about to shit. Trey was my ex. We'd been talking for the past couple of weeks, trying to decide if we were going to try to work shit out. I guess that shit isn't going to happen now. Who the fuck is this? Yo, put Britt on the phone, nigga, Trey barked. Nah, Britt can't come to the phone right now, playboy. She a little busy trying to pull this nut up out of me. And do me a favor, stop calling her damn phone so fucking early in the morning. Fuck. Ride that shit, little mama, he gritted, ending the call and throwing my phone on the bed. I know I should be pissed about what he just did, but for some reason, that shit turned me the fuck on. He started fucking me so good, a bitch was shedding some tears. I don't know if I like that type of dick. Dick like that can make you lose your damn mind. He flipped me over and was pounding the fuck out of my pussy. If I ain't never been fucked like this before in my life was a person, that hoe would be me. Damn. He turned me over and slid in from behind. This nigga slammed in me so hard my ass almost went flying across the room. Lil mama, let me tell you something. This pussy, whap, is whap, fire, whap, as, whap, fuck, whap. He roared, and that shit did it for me. With him smacking and pounding my ass, I was leaking like a faucet. Shit. Oh, God, I'm coming. Oh, fuck, I'm coming so hard. I think you broke my pussy because it won't stop. I screamed so damn loud, you would have thought this nigga was killing me. Nah, I ain't break it. I fucked it how it should be fucked, little baby. Oof, fuck, this some good pussy, he growled as he let loose in the condom. A few minutes later, we got up and took a shower. I was so damn tired. I knew I was going to sleep the day away. Oh, yeah, cancel that nigga, he said, pulling me into him. I didn't respond, but I damn sure heard him. Damn, I love me a thug out, rude ass nigga. And that's the end of that chapter. Well, good on Brit. Oh my God. So listen, Sean is a new character because we didn't even know that Cannon had a brother, right? Remember, Cannon was the crazy killer. And Cam, their friend, is the one that they use to do the computer shit and the fucking pick the lock shit, you know? Remember when they was breaking in? It was Cannon and Cam. Where the fuck was Sean at? I guess he was somewhere fucking some other bitch. But anyway, nice to meet you, Sean. Nice to meet you. And we didn't know he had a sister and her name Mercedes. And apparently she's stupid. Because that's what his mama said. And she need to be slapped. The sister needs to be slapped. All right. Did I miss anybody? I don't think so. I think I spoke to everybody. All right, here we go. Chapter 7, Nas. Hey, babe, where are you headed? She asked, kissing my lips. Sup, I'm headed over to Priest's house. The new cook started this morning. Bear, what the hell are you cooking? I peeked over her shoulder to see what the hell she had going on. My bear was putting in the effort to try and cook, but her ass just ain't there yet. Even though I had my mother-in-law cooking for me now, I still miss my girl, Miss Carol. Child, listen, I ain't never tasted her damn food, but I miss Miss Carol because she just seemed like their missing mom or something, you know? I don't know. Anyway, there will never be another one like her. Her husband decided to retire and move in the house in Florida that we bought him. Yeah, why wouldn't he? Shit. Before he left, he dropped off a book of recipes of hers, and I've been doing a little cooking myself. I'm making you some eggs and bacon. I didn't know you were going over there, she pouted. Hell yeah, I need to see what type of skills her ass got. I called Zoe and put my request in for lunch. I'm gonna eat your food too, since you worked so hard to cook it, I told her as I sat down at the table. Babe, that shit was crazy last night. I still can't believe how bad Cannon beat that boy ass and he was still talking shit. She can't bring that nigga around us, and I feel bad that she's in a fucked up position like that. Priest isn't feeling his ass, and neither am I. That nigga lucky I ain't put his ass in the dirt last night. Only reason he's still breathing is because of Tiff and her daughter, I said, as she placed my breakfast in front of me. These cheese, eggs, and bacon look good as hell. That was until I put the shit in my mouth. Bea, what the fuck is going on with these damn eggs? This shit tastes like ass and cheap ass at that. I looked at her ass with my face all damn twisted. Her ass burst out laughing. I done had my share of badass, and this shit tastes just like it. Boy, ain't shit wrong with them eggs. I used a little bit of this oil and scrambled them up for you, she laughed. Bruh, I don't want that shit. I'm scared to even try this bacon. Fuck that. I'm about to go get my ass something to eat. Whatever the fuck you did, don't do that shit no more. Bring your ass on if you coming with me, because I ain't bringing you no damn plate back. That's fucked up, Nasir. You shouldn't talk about my food like that, she laughed. What's fucked up is that you tried to feed me that nasty shit. I grabbed my keys and headed for the door. I bet by the time I got to the car, her ass was walking out the door because she knew she wasn't eating that shit she cooked. For old time's sake, I sent Tiff a text to let her know that Priest and Zoe got a new cook, and she better bring that ass. I told her to leave her nigga if she wanted him untouched. Ma and Omari must be having a good time. I called to check on him, and she said that he was staying over with her and she wasn't cooking this weekend. She shrugged as I pulled out of the driveway. I don't know if building her that guest house out back was a good idea because her ass done got too comfortable back there. I've been contemplating on burning it down and just telling her we can't rebuild it. I was serious as hell, and Bear was about to cough up a damn lung. She was laughing so hard. Boy, you need Jesus. You can't burn down my mama's shit because you want her to move in with us. Who are you? And where the fuck did you come from? She asked, shaking her head at me. Pulling into Priest's driveway, we got out and walked inside, heading straight to the kitchen. When we walked in, Zoe was feeding their daughter, Marley. Wait, they got a baby? Oh, that's the baby girl, right? Because she was pregnant with a baby girl when the last book ended, right? So she had the little boy. And because I was about to say, ain't that little baby girl, that little baby named something else. Her name's Sasha. This ain't the other lady, baby. Hey, Nakia, welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. Yeah, that baby's name is Sasha. All right. Anyway, she was feeding their daughter Marley and talking to Big Mama while Little Priest was eating and playing with Sasha. Right, boom, there it go. I should have just read. All right, Zoe took this motherhood thing serious and she ain't play about her kids. Shit, when she had Marley, she had to put her foot down with my brother because that crazy nigga was trying to have another damn baby. I'm cool on that shit. My damn son was enough for right now. Boy, sit your ass down and tell me what happened last night. I called your ass after Zoe tried to give me the lowdown, but this effer act like she can't tell a story right. Big Mama spoke while she fucked that damn food up she was eating. Uncle Nasir, come sit by me, Sasha said with excitement. That little girl was something else. She was growing up and so beautiful. Okay, baby, give me a minute. I need to fix me a plate. That shit looked good as hell. I saw the new cook placing more food on the bar. She looked as if she was a tad bit younger than Miss Carol. I looked at my wife and her damn plate was so full the shit was about to fall off. There, where my plate at? I asked her, shaking my head. Over there on the damn rack, nigga. Wait a minute. She like, hell, you better get one out the dish rack, nigga. What the fuck? I'm not fixing your plate. She like, I fix my shit. You fix yours. This shit looks good, babe. You better make sure you get you some of these mixed greens and cabbage. I tasted a little bit of those and Lord, they melt in your damn mouth. Cass greedy ass said, I don't know if I'm feeling how they acting over her damn food, disrespecting my OG Miss Carol like that. Fuck that. This her kitchen and Addie better recognize that shit. The test gonna be how she takes to me and what this food talking about. If shit don't work for me, we gonna have to let her ass go, I whispered to Cass. Babe, how you gonna come up in here talking about we gonna have to let her go? This ain't your house and you can't fire her. Cass was laughing, but I was serious as hell. You must be Nasir. I'm Addie. Miss Zoe told me that I had to take extra care of you and to make sure I cooked whatever you needed. I made all of your favorites as she requested, and I hope you enjoy them. Let me know if there's anything else I can get for you. She also told me you were very close to Miss Carol, and I want you to know that I'll never try to take her place. No, you could never do that. And I'm glad we have that understanding. How you doing, though? A little advice, be careful around these parts. Did they tell you where Miss Carol is and how she got there? If I was you, I wouldn't agree to cook at nobody else's house other than this one. I smiled at her and proceeded to fix my plate. If she knew like I did, she would go get her ass a gun and carry that shit around in her apron. Nasir, Zoe and Cass yelled out. What? She needs to be careful fucking with this family, I shrugged and finished fixing my plate. It's okay, I already know everything. Mr. Priest and Mrs. Chamber didn't leave anything out. She smiled and patted me on the arm. Boy, hurry up and get your ass situated and tell me what went on at the club, Big Mama fussed. Ma, Tiff is engaged, and she wanted us to meet her fiancé. Well, the nigga seemed like he controls that situation they got, and he disrespectful as fuck. I mean, Cannon was giving his ass attitude, but so the fuck what? That's just who Cannon is. The fucked up thing about it is the nigga threw up the abortion shit in Cannon's face, and my nigga went beast mode on his ass. This nigga said, fuck it, snatched Tiff ass up and walked away with her ass. That shit was the best part of the night. He watched his girl get carried off by a motherfucking boss and couldn't do shit about it. Damn, this chicken salmon. I said as I bit down on another piece. Taste the damn mac and cheese, babe. My greedy ass wife spoke with a mouthful of food. I think I might like little Miss Addie. I'm gonna need to feel her out and see how shit goes. Lord have mercy, that damn Cannon is something else. Well, have y'all checked on Tiff to see if her ass was alive? We all know Cannon ass got a screw missing. It's always the fine ones that will get your ass caught up. Just as Big Mama asked that question, Tiff came walking in with her daughter. You almost scared me. I'm sorry, y'all. Yeah, you didn't get me this time. Hey, can I get a little time on this? Like maybe a minute, because it's good and cold. Put that in the garbage. That's the dry part. Thank you. Sorry, y'all. Hey, y'all, she spoke, placing the seat down, pulling Anaya out and passing her to Big Mama. The fuck wrong with you? You look like you walked through the gates of hell and the devil spit your ass back out, I spoke, and everyone fell out laughing. Bruh, I haven't been to sleep and I can't sleep right now. I'm hungry as hell, though, and this food smells amazing, she stated. walking over to the food bar, and it looked like her ass was limping. I'm glad Zoe took the kids to the playroom, because a nigga want to know what went down after her ass was snatched up. Tiff, this little doll looks just like you. I should beat your ass for not keeping in touch with us, Big Mama told her. I'm sorry, Ma. It won't happen again, she said to her as she walked back to the table. Bruh, why the hell you limping like that? That nigga put his hands on you? I asked with my face frowned up because today would be a good day to kill a nigga. No, my legs are just a little sore, is all she said. Lord, you done slid down on the devil's dick. I know that type of walk from anywhere. I may be older than you, but I damn sure know when you done got a hold of some good pipe, Big Mama said. Wait a minute! Oh, Lord. Oh, my God. All right, Big Mama said. And Tiff looked down at her food like that bitch was going to walk off her plate. Thank you. Big Mom, Cass, and Zoe burst out laughing, and I was looking from their ass to Tiff. It took a minute for me to realize what the fuck went down. My fucking nigga. This nigga was about to shake some shit up and act a fucking fool. Tiff better be ready, because she done fucked up and let that nigga in. And that's the end of that chapter. Child, listen. Oh, my God. Listen. Right. Y'all, listen. Oh, my God. Today, Big Mama is a whole ass fool. Yes, wifey. She got a hold to that heavy meat. Yes, honey. That heavy meat will fucking throw your hips out of whack. Change your whole fucking walk. You was bow-legged at first. Now you knock-kneed in a motherfucker. Mm-hmm. That's the heavy meat. Yup. That's the heavy meat. All right. Let me get this time stamp. Oh, my God. I need to know what's going to happen with this dude. I got a feeling her nigga, what's his name? Marlo. I got a feeling he going to beat Tiff ass because Cannon ain't going to stop. So, I don't know. We about to see, though. Chapter 8, Cannon. I can't believe I fucked up like that. I had no intentions on fucking with Tiff ever the fuck again. Don't get it twisted. I'm still pissed the fuck off with her ass. Having her in my house and being that close to her just pulled that shit out of me. The need to punish her pussy was too much for a nigga like me to handle. Now that I've been inside and feeling the way her pussy gripped my dick, it's a fucking problem for me. It was almost 7 in the evening and I haven't heard shit from Sean with my damn car. I can't believe I let that nigga drive my Rolls Royce Wraith. Not the Wraith. Lord have mercy. You let him? Well, that's your brother. Well, I don't know. That nigga might not know how to drive. Grabbing my phone, I dialed his ass up. Yeah. Bruh, where is my damn car? The nigga sounded like he was asleep. My bad. I had a long night and morning. I'm about to get up, and I'll drop it off, he spoke. Just meet me at my house. She been calling me like crazy, and we were supposed to stop by the other day. You still got Shorty with you? Yeah, she gonna chill here until I get back. Damn, you never let a chick stay over. Brick must have given you some special pussy, I laughed. Nigga, all I can do is throw up my hand saying thank you to the man and say hallelujah. He burst out laughing. Boy, you stupid. Okay, Neo, I'll be there in 20 minutes. Wait a minute. What was that song from Neo? Whatever it was about the love was so good that he wanted to say thank you to God or something. Whatever, child, with his bald-headed hoe ass. Anyway, I'll be there in 20 minutes, I told him, hanging up and ordering me an Uber. It took me a few minutes for the Uber to come, and by the time I got to my mom's, Sean was pulling up. Right on time, because I damn sure was going to wait in the car for your ass. I wasn't about to get cussed out by myself. We in this shit together, nigga. We both burst out laughing because I felt the same damn way. We going to take this abuse together. My mama didn't play with us at all with her crazy ass. Using my key to get inside the house, we could hear her talking shit on the phone with her best friend, Sherry. We walked into the kitchen and she damn near dropped the phone. Sherry, let me call you back in a minute. My two knucklehead-ass boys done walked their ass up in here like they right, she spoke, and I knew she was gonna be on one. Mom, before you even start, we got caught up handling business. Sean knew damn well she didn't give a damn about what we had going on. Nigga, shut your dumb ass up and sit down. I swear to God, y'all gonna make me sucker slide y'all asses. I have been calling both of you, and y'all asses don't answer your damn phones. It could be an emergency, and y'all wouldn't know shit. I know this. You better get your shit together and act like you got some damn sense. Sadie's been talking about moving out, and I need y'all to talk to her. She done got with that no good ass nigga, and I know he's the reason she wants to go. He's always yelling at Jeremiah, and I'm not having that. She damn sure won't be taking Jeremiah with her. Y'all better talk to her. She's talking to us like we can make Sadie stay. Ma, Mercedes is grown. If she wants to move out, then you can't stop her from doing that. But if a nigga mistreating Jeremiah, now that's a different conversation. You gonna have to let go at some point and live your life for a change. Stop worrying about us and stop stressing yourself over something that eventually has to happen. I needed her to really think about what I was saying to her. I'm going to have a talk with my sister, and if I find out that nigga that she's messing with is fucking with my nephew, then we got a problem. Brashear, I'm not trying to hear that y'all grown shit. Besides, this house is too big for me to be in here by myself. If she moves out, I'm going to sell it and move in with you or your brother. I felt that shit in my dick, because if she moved in with me, my boy wouldn't get no action. Lil' mama can't move in with me. Hell no. What? Nah, Dukes. Get that out your thought process. I like to watch my girl ass bounce when she walks, and I can't do that shit if your cock blocking ass in the next room. You will straight fuck up my vibe. Brashear will buy you a smaller crib, Sean dumbass said, and she popped his ass upside his head. Only my family called me by my legal name. Ma, we'll talk to her about it, but for now, you need to focus on you, I said to her, kissing her cheek. Okay, I'll leave it alone and let you handle it. What's this I hear about Tiffany being home and got a baby? Now, that's some shit right there. I hope you don't get all worked up over it. If she's not bothering you, just let her be. And hopefully, you won't have to cross paths with her, she stated. Too late. Paths have been crossed, and this nigga done showed his entire ass. I wanted to punch this nigga Sean in his throat. Brashear Mason, please tell me you didn't hurt that girl. She looked at me with concern in her eyes. When I was going through my shit, my mom was the only one that could keep me together. I was ready to kill Tiff, and it took a lot to get my shit together. She good. We had a talk, and that's it, I shrugged. Yo, I need to get back to the house. Baby girl hungry. Ma, I'll check on you in a couple of days to make sure you straight. I'm glad Sean interrupted, because this is a conversation I ain't want to have. I love you, Ma. I pulled her in for a hug, and we headed for the door. Bro, you better find Brenda a new house or talk Mercedes into staying home, because I'm telling you now, I can't do it. I love my mama to death and will lay a nigga down over her, but we can't live under the same roof. She will fuck up my pussy rotation. My dick already feeling some type of way just having this damn conversation. This nigga was crazy. Nigga, if we have to buy her something smaller, best believe you coming up off that bread. I laughed at his ass. 30 minutes later, I was pulling in front of his crib. We dapped it up and he jumped out. I decided to stop by one of my traps to make sure things were good. Yo, where Brock at? I asked, walking inside. He's in the back doing the count, Lonnie said, as he continued to bag up our product. Sup, how's business treating us? I questioned, walking into the room and taking a seat. We good over here. I meant to call you earlier. I saw your girl at the mall with her dude. Why you ain't tell me she was back in town? She said she was getting married out in Cali later this year. The more people bring her up, the more pissed I get. My phone was going off. Dina calling. Who the fuck is Dina? Okay, whatever. Oh, that's the girl that he was fucking, that he called Tiff. Okay, that's her name. Child, listen, we don't like her. I guess she was over being mad at me, and now her ass wanted to get digged down. Yeah. So you wasn't gonna call me and apologize? I can't believe she was really trying to keep this shit going. D, I apologize to you, Shorty, the day it happened. Why are you calling me on some bullshit? You know I don't do that back and forth shit. All she wanted to do was argue, and that shit was irritating as fuck to me. I want to see you. I miss you, baby, and I just got upset. You know I be in my feelings when it comes to that bitch. I swear this girl be giving me crazy vibes when dealing with her ass. She gonna make me choke the shit out of her with the name calling shit. Yo, watch your fucking mouth. And I'm not in the mood to chill tonight. I'll call you when I need some pussy. I hung up on her ass. Man, take your angry energy ass on up out of here. We got good vibes going on and I don't need that shit around me. I don't want that shit rubbing off on me. I need to get me some pussy. And if I go home with an attitude, I can kiss the pussy goodbye. So bye, nigga. I had to laugh at this crazy nigga. Rock and I have been rocking since grade school. His mom is Miss Sherry, my mom's best friend. Okay, well, thank you for putting some context to this nigga Brock and why you talk to him like that. Fuck you, nigga. I hope Asia stops all pussy action on your ass. I burst out laughing because this nigga's face was priceless. Hating ass nigga, he yelled as I walked out to head home. By the time I got home, it was a little after 11. Walking into my bedroom, I could still smell her scent and my dick instantly got hard. Just thinking about her ass being laid up next to that nigga was pissing me off. I've never wanted anything in my life as bad as I wanted her ass right now, and I get what I want. I snatched up my keys and left out. That's right, go get your bitch. It took me about 20 minutes to get over to her mother's house. Parking across the street, I sent her a text. Come sit on my dick. What? I can't do that. You know my fiance is here, Cannon. I'm outside. Don't make me show my ass. She didn't text back, so I assumed she was coming out. A few minutes later, she was walking her beautiful ass out the door. I guess having a baby enhanced her weight because damn, this girl was fine as fuck. The way her hips swayed back and forth as she walked always had my ass drooling. Cannon, are you crazy? This is fucked up on so many levels. Are you trying to cause problems for me? Look, I enjoyed every minute of being with you last night. I just can't do that shit. I'm engaged to be married, she sighed with her face twisted. That sounds like a you problem. Just as long as that nigga don't put his hands on you, I don't give a fuck about this little bullshit-ass relationship. So, when you stopped fucking with me, you decided you didn't want to fuck with women anymore? I asked her. We had an agreement that if she ever got the urge to be with a woman, she would let me know. I've changed. You know that shit happens, right? Just because I've been with women don't mean I can't go back to fucking men, she snapped. I'm just curious as to how you got with this sucker-ass dude, but fuck all that. I need some pussy, and the only pussy I want to feel is yours, so I need you to come and ride this dick, I told her, as I unzipped my pants and freed my little homie. Nigga, ain't shit little about your homie, but okay. Nigga, you crazy as hell. I'm not gonna fuck you while my dude is inside the house. Reaching over, I pushed her legs apart and rubbed my fingers on her fat ass pussy through the fabric of her shorts. A moan escaped her beautiful ass lips, and I knew I had her. I slid my fingers inside of her shorts, massaging her clit. The more I rubbed her shit, the louder she became as she gyrated her pussy on my fingers. You gave that nigga some pussy? I asked her, because if she did, I was gonna kill his ass. I don't know how she was gonna work that shit out. All I know is that nigga better not ever smell or taste this pussy again. No, she groaned as I tugged at her shorts to pull him off. Come get on this dick, baby. Pulling her over into my lap, hovering over me, I slid my dick back and forth over her slit. Come on, y'all. In the car? I'm annoyed. I am annoyed. Are y'all annoyed? I heard all of y'all say yes because you stopped fucking reading. Cannon, this is so wrong, she whispered as I guided her down on my dick. Fuck, this pussy is good as fuck, I gritted, gripping her ass while she moved up and down. This dick feels fucking good, she whispered, biting down on her bottom lip. The fuck faces that she was making was killing a nigga. Coming over here was a bad idea because this the type of pussy that I have you on a murder spree. As I fuck the shit out of her, all I could think about is different ways to kill her nigga. That's it, baby. Ride the fuck out of this dick, I growled, pounding her shit out. Cannon, damn, I miss this dick. She was so caught up that she slipped up. Say that shit, baby. Say what the fuck you feel, I roared. Fucking that shit out of her. I love you. Oh, God, I'm coming. She screamed, and those words sent me over the edge. God damn. Cum shot through my ass so hard, I felt paralyzed. I couldn't move, and she was still riding my dick trying to get her another nut. Gathering my composure, I lifted her off me and pulled her out of the car. Picking her up, pinning her against the car as she eased down on my dick. I was so hungry for this girl, I wanted her to feel this dick. Slamming inside of her, she held onto my neck and cried out my name. Neither of us gave a fuck that we were outside of her mother's house with her so-called fiance steps away. This was a dangerous game we were playing, and I ain't give a fuck as long as I had her wrapped around my dick. And that's the end of that chapter. Listen, outside? That's what I'm talking about. Child, if you ain't never fucked your man outside, you better make arrangements to do that shit ASAP. ASAP. A-A-A-S-A-P. Oh my God, T.I.'s problematic ass, but I love that song. Anyway, that was the end of that chapter, child. Ain't nothing like having a breeze on your naked ass. And I ain't talking about the one from like a fan or the, you know, the air conditioner vent up in the ceiling. I'm talking about Mother Nature smacking that ass, saying, good girl, ride him, cowboy. Anyway, sorry. Let me get to... Oh, my... Y'all know any fucking thing so to come out of my fucking mouth, child. Sorry about that. I ain't apologizing. Fuck that. Y'all in the fucking speakeasy. It is what it is. You never know what the fuck you gonna get. Anyway, I just saw Mo. Did I speak to you, Mo? Child, I can't remember. But hey, girl, hey. Just that quick. I don't know what they be putting in my coffee, child. But, all right, here we go. Chapter 9, Sean. The sound of my doorbell was going off and I had just slid out of the pussy. I don't know what the fuck little mama got inside her shit. That shit was causing my ass to have abandonment issues. I can't tell you how many times I done fucked her ass in almost 48 hours. Fuck! Who the fuck is ringing my damn doorbell like that? I barked, throwing on my sweats. Child, listen. Ain't nothing like being woke up by a certain group of folks early on a goddamn Saturday morning because they ringing your fucking doorbell. Anyway, snatching my door open, I wanted to drop kick this hoe back to where she came from. Hey, can we talk for a minute? I couldn't believe Stasia was standing at my fucking door. No, now ain't a good time. I have company, and it's disrespectful as fuck to be standing here talking to you. You know what it is. There are no second chances with me. You wanted to fuck the homie, and you lucky I didn't slice your fucking throat behind it, I told her. Stasia and I, is it Stasia or Stasia? Which one y'all like? Anyway, this hoe, we gonna call her Stasia. I can't remember. Y'all know I'm gonna fuck it up. Stasia and I had been together for a year when she decided that she wanted to hop on the next nigga dick. There is one thing that I'm big on, and that's loyalty. If a bitch can't be loyal to me, then I don't wanna. Well, Chris Brown told you these hoes ain't loyal, sir, so what the fuck, Sean? Anyway, I was really feeling her ass. And then she goes and do some dumb shit like that. Babe, are you coming back to bed? I heard from behind me, and a smile formed on my face. When I turned to respond to Brittany, my dick instantly got hard because her ass was standing there butt-ass naked. Baby girl was thick as hell, but she ain't have an overly big ass. Her deep brown eyes and medium brown complexion complimented her. And she was fine as fuck, just the way I like my woman. I guess the shit she was doing was my payback for answering her phone. Stasia looked as if she wanted to spit fire on both of our asses. I just slammed and locked the door, walking up on Britt, pulling her back to bed. Yo, I see you on some petty shit, I said, kissing her on her lips. Nah, I was just ready for you to come back to bed. But seriously, I think it's time for you to take me to Tiff's mama house. I don't want to fuck up nothing you got going on, she said, and I wasn't feeling her leaving right now. Baby girl, you not fucking a damn thing up over here. If I had a woman, you wouldn't have your fine ass in here. I'm a grown ass man. I don't cheat on my woman because I know better. I don't play with people's feelings because that shit will get you killed. Boom. Big facts. Playing with somebody's fucking feelings will get your fucking meat blown smooth up out your taco. And I don't think nobody want that, y'all. I know I don't. But anyway, when I made a move and make you my girl, I think he meant when I make a move and make you my girl, it's going to be you that fucked up, which is why that bitch is on the other side of the door. Don't ask me a question you really don't want the answer to, because I'm going to give you the truth. I'll never leave a female on. If this is just a fuck for me, I'm going to let you know what it is. Now, come lay your fine ass down and let me suck that pussy to sleep, I told her. Lord have mercy. Well, pardon me. I don't think I've ever had that. Let me put that, just suck it to sleep. I don't think I want you to, sir, that's too much sucking. Like, I don't know if I want that. Like, let me think about it. That's me talking, y'all. Like, I don't know if I want you to suck that to sleep, because no God. Anyway, she climbed in bed and I did just what I said I would do. The next morning, I heard loud talking and jumped out of bed, grabbing my gun. The closer I got to the noise, all I could do was brace my damn self. Walking into the kitchen, Brittany was standing at the stove with one of my shirts on and I could see most of her naked ass. Ma, what the hell are you doing over here? I wanted to come over and cook you some breakfast, but I see you got your flavor of the night here. Baby, you'll get more respect if you date him before giving up the ass. Let this nigga whine and dine you for a little while. Stop hopping on the dick because the nigga look good on the outside. Just because they look good to you doesn't mean they good for you. This nigga could be that shit crazy and you don't find out until after you done had his baby and said I do. I was going to call you a bunch of hoes, but my spirit is feeling good today, so I decided to drop a few gems on you. Sean, I'll talk to your hoe ass later, baby. She smiled, walking to the door. Bruh, you going to make me take my key, I said, shaking my head at her rude ass. Boy, go to hell. You ain't taking shit. I'm about to go check on your brother and see what his crazy ass up to, and your ass better not tell him I'm coming over. When she walked out, I slammed the door. Yo, I'm sorry, baby girl. My mom can be rude as fuck sometimes. I hope what my Duke said didn't offend her. I don't bend easily, and for some reason, what she said was right. Now, how she said it was a little out of line, but I get it. We're good. I'm about to go get dressed so you can drop me off. She left the kitchen, and I followed behind her. I'm going to drop you off so you can check in with your people. I'm coming back to get you after I handle some business. Maybe we can go get some dinner later if you good with that. For some reason, I didn't want her to feel like she was just a fuck to me. Even though we just met, I was feeling her. I learned the insides of that pussy and can break that shit down like a fraction. If another nigga goes inside of her other than me, my ass gonna know about it. Besides that, we had some meaningful conversations. I got to know her, and she definitely got to know a little about me. And that's the end of that chapter. Child, listen. Okay, Miss Pretty. Thank you for stopping in to say, oh, you talking about the other book. Okay. Well, thank you for being here, darling. I appreciate you. That was the end of that chapter, y'all. All right, trying to get this time stamp, child. This thing never wants to cooperate. Okay, y'all, we are breezing through these little chapters, child. I'm hoping y'all liking it so far. Because if not, I don't know what to tell you besides click off. Chapter 10, Tiff. This shit is getting out of hand, and I'm fucking up big time. I can't believe I fell weak to this man. I didn't think that he would want anything to do with me, and all of a sudden, he's pounding my insides. Oh, so fucking good. I've cheated on my man, and all I could think about was when I would get my next hit of cannon. Oh, child, listen. She addicted. Lord have mercy. The thought of him massaging my insides was driving my ass crazy. I called Brittany and told her to get her ass here now. Tiffany, what is going on with you? I thought you said you were staying and he was leaving today, my mom asked when I walked into her bedroom to pack up Anaya's clothes. Ma, it's just best that I go back. I promise I'll be back to visit you as soon as I can. Things are getting out of hand and I can't be here right now. I know she's upset that we're leaving, but it's for the best. The only thing that's getting out of hand is that you're about to make the biggest mistake of your life and marry a man that you don't even love. The man you love and want is the man that had you screaming to the God, or sorry, to the good Lord above when you took your hot ass outside and took a ride on the stairway to heaven with his ass. Wait a minute. Her mama was watching them? Oh my God, that is disgusting. What the hell? Hey, Deborah, welcome. Thank you for being here, darling. I appreciate you. She smirked and my damn mouth dropped to the floor. Oh my God, you saw us? What if Marlo saw us? I was pacing back and forth, nervous as hell. Girl, that nigga was asleep. I was watching your back anyway. I would have sent a fire signal to your ass if he had woken up. I just need you to think about all of this shit. I think you're settling for something that you don't have to settle for. You can have the real deal if you just go to him. I know you're thinking about Anaya. You have to do what makes you happy, baby. And something tells me it's much more to that nigga than you know. I've always been able to tell when a nigga full of shit and that nigga you got in there got shit running out his ass. I heard what she was saying. I just didn't want my daughter growing up with her parents in separate homes. Girl, fuck that nigga. Anyway, Mom, I'll be all right. I was so embarrassed to know that she knew what I did last night. When I got the text from Cannon, Marlo had already fallen asleep. After I came back in and washed up, I felt like shit for betraying him. So I decided this morning to go back to Cali with him. What? I just realized that this girl said she going home. I thought she was packing her shit to go over to Cannon house, but she talk about going back to Cannon. Oh, hell no, bitch. I'm sorry, y'all. Oh my God. I told y'all this is like how I be acting when I'm reading all by myself, talking cash money shit. Oh, Lord have mercy. If I wanted shit to work with us, I had to leave here and be dedicated to my fiance. You got all your things packed? Marlo questioned as he grabbed his bags. Yeah, we have to wait on Britt. She should be here in a few. I purchased her ticket last night when I got mine, I told him. Man, fuck her. She should have had her ass here and stopped being a hoe. That's why I told you to stop hanging with her ass. She was happy as hell that nigga took you, and I don't want that bitch in my house. It's either gonna be me and your daughter or her, and that's all I'm gonna say about that. Now, I get that he's angry, but threatening me about my child will get his ass fucked up. I'm not getting into this shit with you. Just know we're going to have problems when you involve my daughter. As for Brittany, she does what the fuck she wants. I can't tell her how to live her life, nor can you tell me that I can't hang with my best friend. We've been through this, and ain't shit changed. I walked out of the room bumping into Britt. That nigga still on his bitch shit about me, but as always, fuck him, she said. Britt, where the hell have you been? I asked, smiling at her. Having a time of my fucking life, just thinking about his ass gives me the shakes. So, did you get dicked down by a real nigga or you still getting poked by a pencil dick nigga? She burst out laughing and I pulled her down the hall into the kitchen. Sis, that nigga fucked me so good I can still feel him inside of me and I can barely move. When I walk, my pussy is screaming, which is why we getting the fuck out of here. I got you a ticket and you need to go pack your shit. We leave to go back to Cali in a few hours. The look on her face let me know that she wasn't feeling it. What? I'm not trying to leave right now. I have plans on getting with Sean tonight. What happened to us staying for a week? She questioned with her face frowned up. Britt, I'm losing control being back home near him. I fucked Cannon out front last night with Marlo in here sleeping. Now, you know that's some disrespectful shit. I'm afraid of what he's doing to me and the way I'm feeling. Yes, the fuck you can. I would be riding that dick so good, Marlo bitch ass would feel it in his motherfucking sleep. We both burst out laughing because this girl was nuts. Britt, please do this for me. We can come back when I get stronger. I need to be far away from him. I had no idea that he would forgive me. Ooh, wee, this nigga Cannon got that disrespectful dick. He done made a bitch want to run or throw it all away. I know that's the fuck right. Bitch, you sound like your ass just had major surgery or some shit. Who forgave you though, sis? I don't think you're forgiven just yet. He fucking his way to that point. Right now, your ass is getting revenge fucked, and I know that pipe down is something serious. Let me go pack my damn bag and call Sean. You owe me for this shit. I'm changing my seat on the plane. I don't want to be nowhere near fuck nigga row. Shaking my head as she walked away. Out, sorry, I headed to the room to go pack. It's a break in the chapter. Let me sip some coffee, child. Why she want Brittany to leave with her just because her old pigeon-toed ass nigga want to go home? I don't like that. Fuck his pelican face ass. Let him go home by himself. Hell, ain't nobody tell his punk ass to come. Don't he have a little low-rate empire to run? So it's not a whole empire, it's just a pyre. That's what the fuck you need. Go back to your pyre, sir, and start working on getting the E and the fucking M. Hell, punk ass Chauncey. I'm mad. Girl. She said row F seat in. What the fuck? She said fuck nigga row. I guess, you know, it's three seats on the row. don't know. They must be on a jumbo jet, child, unless they sitting in the middle of the seat. But whatever, child. Yes, his old pelican face ass. Fuck him. The way they was beating his fucking beak in the club, that nigga shit smooshed in a bitch. It was going on 5 West Coast time by the time we got home. I was exhausted from traveling, and all I wanted to do was sleep. I decided to take a nice warm shower so that I could climb in bed. Closing my eyes as the water cascaded down my body caused my mind to drift back to the night in Cannon's bed. That man had a way of making me feel like I was going to combust inside. Just his touch did something to me. It was nothing and no one that could make me feel the way he did. It's just when shit went bad with us, I thought there was no hope for us. The thoughts of him and me rubbing the soap on my body made me hot, and my pussy was throbbing. Sliding my fingers between my thighs, rubbing my clit, had me feeling so good that I needed to come. Grinding against my fingers with thoughts of him pounding my insides relentlessly. Fuck. The sensation felt so good I couldn't stop the moans that escaped my mouth. Let me help you with that, Marlowe whispered. Ew, sorry, as he began massaging my clit and moving my hand out the way. I was so horny, but I know I shouldn't be sleeping with him right now. Hell no, because then you just get fucked by Cannon. Like, ew, that's too much. Too many different... Anyway, babe, I just want to come quick. I cried out as he pushed himself inside, pounding me like he had something to prove and wasn't proving shit. I was damn turned off. My pussy got dry. Fuck, you've been denying me this pussy for days now. Fuck, this pussy good. Throw that shit back, he growled. And I couldn't do it. It was like everything went cold and I no longer wanted to come. The messed up thing is I feel like I'm cheating on Cannon. What the fuck is going on with me? You feel that shit? Come with me, babe, because I'm about to bust, he gritted as he released, and I faked as if I was coming with him. I'd have been like, get your dick out of me, sir. Oh, my God. After I got out the shower and got in bed, Marlo came out of his closet fully dressed and grabbing his keys off the dresser. I need to go check on my spots and make sure everything good. I shouldn't be long. I didn't care that he was leaving. This wasn't nothing new. His ass is always gone, and it was always to handle his business. Just as soon as I got into a deep sleep, I heard my phone vibrating. Picking it up and noticing that it was a text message from an unknown number, y'all. It says, so, you leaving? Don't say shit to me about it? Cannon, we had to come back home. I didn't think that I had to say anything to you. What we did was a mistake, and I'm getting married, and I can't be involved with you. I wish things could have been different, but I can't do this to a man that loves me unconditionally. He's my daughter's father. I have to think about her in all of this. Bet. Live your life, beautiful. Thank you. I'm glad you understand. He never responded, and I know he was pissed off. I don't know what the fuck is wrong with me. I'm as tough as they come, but when it comes to him, I act all soft and shit. I assumed he found out that I left from his brother or Nas. I did call them and let him know I was leaving to come back home. I had a talk with Nasir and Priest about being at my wedding. I'd like for my family to be here, and they agreed to put shit aside and come out for the wedding, which was 5 months away. I erased all of the text messages between Cannon and I and drifted into a good sleep. And that's the end of that chapter. Child, what is you doing with that fucking... Ugh. This nigga's a fuck boy. I wouldn't even want to be with a nigga that got beat the fuck down. I don't know. Man, he got beat up more than once in the same damn night. Nigga, you just got beat up. How you gonna protect me? You ain't no baller, Kenny. You a piece of shit, yo. Trash. Damn, and your dick trash too, nigga. Girl, how you get pregnant by a nigga with a pencil dick? Well, I guess them be the ones. They just drop that shit off just right there. Long and thin. Nobody want that shit. Get your slender dick ass out of here. Slender man. Oh, celery stock dick ass. Oh, my God. Oh, Chico stick dick ass. Get you. Oh, my God. I am fucking insane. My bad, y'all. I don't have good goddamn sense, and I don't like this nigga. It's something with him. I can feel it. Oh, my God. I've been trying to get this fucking time stamp, but this nigga got me fucked up. I don't like him, y'all. I got a feeling he gonna fucking put his hands on her, and that shit is gonna fucking send what you call it them over the top. And then it's gonna be a fucking bloodbath. Right. Oh, crayon dick ass nigga. Oh, my God. Right, you ain't do shit but dry my cooter mama up, and we in the shower, nigga, and I'm still dry. No, sorry, sir. Chapter 11, Brittany. 3 months later. Okay, so now time has moved forward 3 months. Sean and I have been talking every day, and I even snuck my little thot hot box ass back to Philadelphia to see him for a week. The connection we've made with each other is crazy, and I'm feeling him something serious. Even though we're just getting to know each other, he keeps saying that I won't be living in Cali much longer. I'm not just ready to give up all that I have going on here and move back to Philly with a man I'm just getting to know. Tiff and I own a clothing boutique here in LA, and our business is booming right now. We're planning on opening a second store soon, so moving isn't the best option for me, and I kind of hinted at that, but he ignored the topic. Because he ain't trying to hear that shit, girl. The fuck? That nigga heard everything you said. He just don't give a fuck. I heard my phone going off, and I ran to go grab it. Hey, boo, what's up? I asked Tiff. Hey, do you still have those nausea pills that the doctor gave you a while back? She questioned. I think I have a few left. Let me go check. Why, what's wrong? I feel sick. I can't stop throwing up, and this shit is irritating the fuck out of me. I can't go to the doctor until tomorrow, and I just can't go through this shit all night long. I felt bad for her because she sounded horrible. Yeah, I got some. You coming to get them, or do you need me to bring them over? I knew she probably didn't feel like driving. No, Marlo is on your side of town, and I'll have him stop by and get them, she spoke. All right, I'll have him waiting for him. Oh, shit. Do you think you're pregnant again? Remember, you were like this when you were pregnant with Anaya. Bitch, when you were busting it open for a real nigga, did you use protection? Lord, please say you did, because baby, this shit about to get realer than a motherfucker, and I think I want to rent me a place across the street from you. I can't miss none of this motherfucking hot ass tea. I was sitting on pins and needles waiting for her ass to answer the damn question. No, we were in the heat of the moment. None of that was on our minds. Oh my God. I slept with Marlo several times since him. I can't be pregnant. This can't happen to me. Fuck, she panicked. Baby, oh my God is right. You better go on and call on him, because your ass is going to need all the power he possesses to calm the storm that's coming your way. But I'm here for you, sis. You need me to go to the doctor with you? I asked her because I wanted to witness all this good fuckery. Britt, this shit is not funny. I may have royally fucked up, she yelled. Nah, boo, ain't no maybe in this shit right here. You got into an entanglement, and now your ass is tangled the fuck up around this bitch. I laughed at her ass hung up on me. Poor little Tink. She done danced with the devil and now got a call on the power of Jesus to get her ass out of this mess. Just as I went to grab my chicken bowl from Chipotle out of the fridge, my doorbell was going off. Peeping through the peephole, I saw that it was Marlo's punk ass coming to pick up the medicine for Tiff. Opening the door, he tried walking in and I stopped his ass. Nah, bruh, you can stand right here until I go grab him. Being around that fake ass nigga made my ass itch. Grabbing the pills and walking back out front, this nigga had done walked inside my shit and was sitting on my couch. Nigga, didn't I tell your ass to wait outside? The fuck I look like standing outside for? What you got going on? Trying to find the next nigga dick to hop on? I got a big nigga you can come see about whenever you ready, he smiled, grabbing his dick through his jeans. Nigga, I would never fuck with up. Pussy ass bitch like you. You foul as fuck for that shit, knowing me and Tiff rock hard. I should bust you in your motherfucking head for saying that shit. Get the fuck out of my shit. I threw the bottle at his ass. Whatever, hoe. You better keep that shit to yourself, because she would never believe your hoe ass anyway. He headed for the door and left. I was so fucking mad, I was shaking. I couldn't believe this punk ass bitch said that shit. Yeah, Tiff gonna have to hear about this shit. I wouldn't be a friend if I didn't tell her. Picking up my ringing phone, I was not paying attention to who was calling because I was so pissed. What? I spoke. So you finally answer your fucking phone and then pick up with an attitude? The fuck is wrong with you, Brit? You got a nigga answering your phone while y'all fucking? I thought we were supposed to be working our shit out. This nigga was beyond mad. I had been avoiding his calls, not answering my door, and for the last few months. I was being a little punk because I didn't want to argue with him about me not wanting to be with him. He was the one that fucked shit up with us. He was out fucking every bitch he could find, and he was the one that got caught the hell up. I guess I did lead him to believe that as long as he was trying, we could work on getting back together. I have been with Trey for 5 years, and to find out he was doing me like that was heartbreaking. It took me a long ass time to get my shit together over this nigga. So when Sean answered my phone, that shit made me smile on the inside to know that he was feeling how I did when he heard me. Look, I know what we were trying to do, and I know that shit was a little messed up, but maybe I need to just take some time to rethink everything, I told him. Are you serious? You really doing this shit right now after all of the progress I've made to show you that I'm all about you? As soon as I come back in town, we're gonna sit down and talk about this shit, Brit. I fucking love you, and I'm not gonna allow you to just say fuck us. He hung up, and I had to look at my damn phone. I guess his ass ain't giving up that easy. Ugh, I hate being in difficult shit. This night turned into some depressing shit, so I called it a night. And there's a break in the chapter. Who this nigga? I don't think that you gonna be with him after you done been with Sean. Like, that's hustling backwards or loving backwards or just being a stupid bitch. Like, don't do that. You say he act like a, oh, yeah, well, I mean, because he, what he grabbing his shit, right? Why would you say some shit like that to her? She need to be calling her up and telling her right now. Oh, my God. Okay. My phone jolted me out of my sleep, and I was tired as fuck. I let that shit go to voicemail, and it started back up again. Snatching it off my nightstand, I saw that it was Tiff calling. Hey, sis, I groggily spoke. Brit, where are you? I thought you were meeting me at the doctor's office. Oh, shit. What time is it? You got 30 minutes. I've been calling you for the past hour. Ugh, hurry up, Brit. She hung up on my ass. Jumping out of bed, I rushed to take a shower and left out because LA traffic is a bitch. You telling me. By the time I got to her doctor's office, they had already called her back and the nurse took me back to her. Damn, I'm so glad you made it. They already took a urine sample from me, and I'm just waiting for the doctor to come in, she said, throwing her hand over her face. Bruh, I wish we could smoke when we get out of here, but something tells me that shit won't be happening today. I smiled, and I know she wished she would have left my ass where I was. Right. A few minutes later, the doctor walked into the room. Hello, Miss Bryant. I understand that you're nauseated and having some back and stomach pain, he questioned her. Yes, it's been going on for a few days now, and it just got worse yesterday, she told him. We did a pregnancy test on you. The results were positive. Ooh, sorry, y'all. So that's the reason you're nauseated and having the discomfort in your stomach and back. I'm going to check you out, and we can tell you how far along you are and try to get you feeling better, he spoke. And Tiff ass almost fell off the table. Oh, my God, I get a hold of some monster dick and lose my mind being careless and shit. Dr. Behringer, are you sure? Can you take the test again? She asked him. It was the monster dick and the look on the doctor's face for me. My good sis was losing her shit behind this T. The good old doc was given. Miss Bryant, the test results are accurate. There's no need to retake it. You're definitely pregnant. Lay back and let me get your exam done. He walked to the door and called the nurse into the room. An hour later, we were walking out with Tiff in a panic and almost 11 weeks pregnant. Brit, I have no idea what I'm going to do. I'm so glad that Marlo went out of town this morning and couldn't come with me. Sorry. I have to make some shit up. There is no way I can tell him right now, she cried. Tiff, I don't think Marlo is the person that you truly need to be worried about. If Cannon ever finds out that you're pregnant, knowing it's a possibility that could be his baby, your problems with Marlo are gonna be minimal compared to the shit you gonna have with him. And how the hell do you expect to hide the shit when you're 3 months pregnant? Let's go have lunch. Maybe it'll ease your mind. Where's Anaya if Marlo's out of town? I asked her as we walked to our cars. She's with his mom for a couple of days since I wasn't feeling well. I'm so glad she does have her because I need this time to think, she shrugged. I felt bad for her, but the shit was still hilarious. I need to talk to you about something, but I'll tell you after you calm down a little. I was going to talk to her about what happened with Marlo, but decided to tell her later. she has a lot on her mind right now. You can tell me now, it can't be worse than this shit. I'm going to ride with you and we can come back for my car later. Let's go to Shaquille's since we're close by, she spoke as she got inside of my car. No, we can wait until later, I told her. Once we made it to the restaurant, we had to wait until our name was called. I sure hope the wait isn't long. Something grabbed her attention and I turned to see what the hell she was looking at. Is that Marlo? I questioned, just as she took off walking. Marlo's bitch ass was sitting at a table having lunch with this chick, and she was holding a baby. Who the fuck is this? She yelled, walking up on him. Fuck, Tiff, this nigga couldn't even get his words together. Who the fuck are you walking up on us asking damn questions? The girl put her baby down and jumped up in Tiff's face. Bitch, it's best if you sit the fuck down. This shit ain't about you, and I promise, I don't want to beat your ass over this nigga. Marlo, who the fuck is she? Tiff asked, resting her hand on her waist. I'm the mother of his child and his fiance. And when this bitch flashed her ring in Tiff's face, I almost flatlined. Her damn ring was the exact ring on Tiff's finger, and the baby couldn't have been no more than 6 or 7 months old. So this hoe and Tiff were pregnant around the same time. What? So how the fuck you thought this was gonna work? Is that your baby, Marlo? Tiff screamed, and I knew my girl was about to explode on his ass. Yeah, but let's talk about this shit outside. You in here causing a scene and shit, this pussy-ass nigga said. Nigga, fuck you. You out here got me looking like a fool. How long have you been with him? Tiff asked the chick. None of your fucking business, she spat, and I swear I was ready to tag this hoe. Nigga, you ain't shit. Tiff, this is what I wanted to talk to you about. When this pussy came over to my house last night, he was trying to get me to fuck him. I kicked his ass out of my shit. You were so upset, I didn't want to tell you. But after seeing this shit, you need to get rid of this goofy ass nigga, I told her. And the tears started to flow. I knew when that happened, she was going to fuck this nigga up. Maybe I should have waited. You tried to fuck with my best friend? She yelled. Tiff, this bitch is lying. Marlo grabbed her arm and tried pulling her towards the door. You're not about to go talk to her. Why the fuck she so mad over you being with me, nigga? The chick questioned. Excuse me, I'm going to have to ask all of you to leave, the manager stated when he approached us. Char, chill the fuck out and take my son home, Marlo gritted on her, and she didn't move. Before he could react, Tiff was throwing blows all on that nigga head. He must have forgotten who the fuck he was fucking with. Tiff had done a 360 with her attitude, but don't get it twisted. She will fuck your ass up. Bitch, get the fuck off my man, this Char chick yelled as she tried to swing on Tiff, and that was a bad decision on her part because I beat that bitch ass. The next thing I knew, we were being pulled apart and handcuffed. The manager had called the police on us, and I was even more pissed because they only took me and Tiff to jail. And that's the end of that chapter. I know you lying. Child, listen. Oh, hey, Nikita. Welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. Child... This is some, what the fuck, yo? This nigga out here cheating, but he worried about what the fuck she doing. See, this what I try to tell y'all. Y'all don't be wanting to listen to me. It's not all men, Saki. Listen. Listen. Until you marry that nigga, and sometimes after you marry them niggas, they be single. Okay? They be real fucking single. Every once in a while, you run across a nigga that understands the assignment and ain't out here acting a damn fool and embarrassing you and shit. Mm-mm. Don't embarrass me. Mm-mm. Poor Tiff. She like, nigga, I could have been with a cannon. I mean, with cannon. She could have been with cannon, sitting on a cannon. And she over here with pencil dick. I'm getting this next time stamp, y'all. This is what happened when you play with kids, child. Because he's a little ass kid. Punk ass Chauncey. Tried to tell her. Well, if she wouldn't have been all confused and shit, then well, I don't know. But do we really? I don't know. We don't know what the fuck is getting ready to happen, child. We have no idea. We just gotta wait. Chapter 12, Nas. I was on my way to meet up with the guys. Pop and stepmama just got back in town and he wanted to catch up on what's been going on. As I pulled into the parking lot, Cannon pulled in behind me. What's up? I spoke. Chilling, he shrugged as we walked into Brenda's. I had to sit down and really have a talk with this nigga. I don't know what my cousin did to his ass, but this nigga was geeking the fuck out. What up, old man? I feel like I haven't seen your ass in years. Stepmama done finally let your ass up for air, I laughed. Man, I'm loving every bit of my beautiful wife. She can suffocate me and it wouldn't bother me one bit, he smiled, sipping on his drink. Nah, nigga gotta breathe. I love my bed, but she not about to be taking my motherfucking air. Fuck around and I would be looking and acting like this lunatic ass nigga. I burst out laughing, looking over at Cannon's ass. Man, fuck you, he chuckled. Cannon, what's up with you, man? I heard Tiff came home a few months ago and caused you to lose your mind, Pop said to him. Where did you hear that from? He questioned. Big Mama said you beat her man's ass, took his woman, dog walked her on the devil's dick, and then gave her back with a new lease on life. We all burst out laughing because Big Mama was a damn fool. I'm good. Shorty doing her and we both moving on. Dina and I are in a relationship now and life is good. Oh, Lord. Now, see, she done fucked around and this nigga done took up with this sour patch head ass bitch named Dina. We don't know shit about this bitch. Some hoe he started fucking with, I guess. We don't like her. I'm speaking for all of us. We do not like this bitch. When that happened, I asked him. We made shit official last night. I couldn't believe this nigga got with Dina, money hungry ass. He and I both knew she wasn't the perfect match for him. I was all for him getting him a woman, but Dina just wasn't it. Bro, if you still feeling some type of way about this situation, you not over her. I wouldn't give up on her if that's what you want. Tiff feels like she would be letting her daughter down, and to be honest, I think that's the only reason she would give up her happiness. I've talked to her, and that's what I took from the conversation. She's not in a good headspace, and I think that has something to do with you, Priest said to him, and he just sat there sipping on his drink. Yeah, well, she made her decision. I'm not chasing no woman that's not even in the game to be chased, he stated. I'm with Priest. If you love her, I wouldn't give up so easy. Pray on it and ask God to give you some guidance, Pop told him. Pop, this nigga done murdered hundreds of niggas just because they ass was trying to breathe the same air as him. The only guidance God gonna give his ass is the directions to hell. They were laughing, but I was serious. I know she's your family and I don't want to be disrespectful. In my mind, shit between us is over and there's no need to go back and forth about it. Let's talk business. The operation is growing and we've generated more money than we've ever seen. There's another business that I think we should look into and it's just as lucrative as the drug game. I have a connect for guns. He can get us whatever we want when we want them, Cannon spoke. I'm not sure how I feel about flooding the streets with guns. I almost broke my damn neck to look at my brother. Nigga, you flood them with drugs, so what the fuck is the difference? I questioned. I flood the streets with my diamonds and collect my money from y'all illegal ass niggas, he smiled. Pretty stupid, y'all. Whatever helps you sleep at night. Hey, Casey, I need you to put me an order in, I told her. Sure, what can I get you? She smiled. Let me get a bacon cheeseburger with everything on it, 10 hot wings and some cheese fries. Oh, and let me get some of those crab balls. You sure you ordered enough? Cannon looked at me. All I know is y'all better order because you damn sure ain't getting none of my shit. They put their orders in because their asses knew I wasn't playing. What's up, Cannon? Diamond funky ass spoke, walking up to us. Bitch, he snapped, looking her up and down. How have you been? She asked him. And I had to step in before this nigga made the wrong move. He got married today at 11:13. He don't fuck with funky ass hoes no more and he ain't never gonna forget how your whole ass slipped on another nigga dick in his crib. I heard your new nigga came up missing. How that shit been working out for you? You may need to keep your ass away from this nigga because he not stable and the death rate can go up by one hoe in the next 2 minutes, I told her. This nigga pulled his gun out, looking at it, rubbing it, and then pointed it at her. While Priest's ass was about to bust a lung from laughing so damn hard, the chick Diamond was with was damn near dragging her ass out the door. Boy, your ass is crazy. Pop shook his head. She lucky I was there to save her ass. Had this nigga been alone, he might have put a slug or two in her. They know I was telling the truth. I got a call from an unknown number. I ignored the call and they called right back. Yeah. Hello, I'm trying to reach Nas. My name is Kelly and I work for Tiffany. What's up? Why are you calling me and not Tiff? I asked her. She asked me to call you. She's been arrested and can't get to her money. She said you will send me the money to bail her and Brittany out. If you can, please send me the money. She's pregnant and I really need your help getting them out of there. This girl was talking so damn fast. I heard two things that were of importance, jail and pregnant. Jail? Pregnant? what the fuck is she doing in jail? I blurted out and all eyes were on me. It's a long story, but I'm sure she'll explain it when she talks to you. I know Tiff didn't get her ass locked up and she got a damn baby. And text me the best way to send this money to you and how much you need. I'm on my way to LA. Can you send me her address and where she's being held? Hopefully you'll have her out by the time I get there. I finished talking to her and ended the call. Everything good? Priest looked over at me. Nah, we need to go. Can you call and get us a plane headed to LA? I'll meet you at the airport in an hour. I ain't have to explain shit. We stood up and everyone followed me out of the restaurant. Do you need me on this? Pop questioned. Nah, we good. I'll call you when we land. I dapped him up and he walked back inside. What's up, bro? Cannon waited for me to start talking. Tiff and Brittany are both in jail. I'm not sure what the fuck they did, but I have to go find out. You got your shit going with Dina, so I don't expect you to take this flight with us. If we need you, I'll call you. I think Priest and I got it from here, I told him. Nah, I got the part about her being in jail, but I'm gonna need you to elaborate on the pregnant part. Who's pregnant, he asked, and I couldn't lie to my boy. The chick Kelly that called me said that she was in jail and pregnant. I'm not sure if she was talking about Tiff or Brit. That's all I know. As soon as I find out what's going on, I'll call you. I had a feeling that she was talking about Tiff. I knew this nigga would be on edge, so I kept my thoughts to myself. Don't take off without me and Sean. I shook my head because shit in Cali was about to get real. I text you the info as soon as I hear from Priest. I jumped in my car and called Cass to have her pack me a bag. Priest's ass left as soon as we walked out of the restaurant. When it comes to family, we don't ask no questions. I know her bitch-ass boyfriend better not have her doing no foul shit. I know he's in the streets, and if she got caught up on some shit he got going on, I'm gonna kill that nigga. And that's the end of that chapter. Oh, Lord, y'all. But we know she in jail because of the fight, but they don't know. But I'm thinking Cannon about to lose his complete fucking mind, y'all. Oh, my God. I don't know if this is a good idea. I really don't, y'all. Jesus wept on the cross for me. Not y'all, just me. I don't know what the fuck y'all got going on, but y'all, this is too much. All right, let me get this time stamp, child. Oh, my word, child. Right, that's the next installment, L Boogie. The Chamber Brothers, Marlo and Sean, take California. Oh, my God. Lord, have mercy. You just say the Chamber family takes California because, hell, they treat Sean and fucking, not Marlo, the Chamber Brothers, Cannon and Sean. Marlo is the nigga that Tiff fucking with and got the baby by. Fuck that nigga. Mm-mm. But they treat Cannon like family anyway, so yeah. Mm-mm-mm. A mess, y'all. What are we gonna do here? These folks, they doing too much. And I don't know about y'all, but hey, I can't. Okay. Hey, Jamisha. Welcome, darling. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. You probably going to have to red ball it back, child. Yeah, you're going to have to red ball it back because Lord have mercy. Hey, Akira. Welcome. Thank you for being here, lovey. I appreciate you. Yeah, y'all both going to have to red ball it back because y'all way behind. You think they finna kill Marlo? He going to take that suit to the casket. Oh my God, child. Listen, let's hope that they don't kill his ass because that would be fucked up. All right, here we go. Chapter 13, Cannon. She think this shit a game. Tiff better pray that she's not the one pregnant. I called my brother so that he could take this trip with us. I don't know the details of what he and Brittany have going on, but if she's the one pregnant, he needed to know about it. All I knew is that one of them was pregnant and we gonna get to the bottom of that shit ASAP. My phone was buzzing and it was Sean letting me know that he was pulling up. Hearing about the mess with Tiff caught me off guard that I forgot that Dina was coming over to spend the night with me. I can't believe this shit. We just made things official when you're running off to go play Captain Save-A-Ho, she yelled. I told you what was going on out of respect that you're my girl. I slept with her. You knew that. So don't act like this shit is a surprise to you. Now, it's a possibility that she might be the one that's pregnant. And if that's the case, then I need to know if that's my kid. I'll never be disrespectful to you. I just need to know what's going on. If you can't handle this part of it, let me know. And we can just end this shit before it gets started. I gotta go. I'll call you as soon as I get a chance. Well, at least he was honest with the raggedy bitch, but I feel like it's some bullshit with her. Okay, Akira. But I don't know about this chick. Dina and I had a conversation. I told her everything about Tiff. Oh, about me and Tiff, sorry. I opened the door and she walked out without saying goodbye. I got into the car with my brother. So I dapped him up as he pulled out, jumping on the highway, heading to the airport. I'm glad Priest rented a private plane. It was almost 1 a.m. by the time we made it to Cali. I just called Tiff and Britt's phone and didn't get an answer. I got a text from Kelly saying they were released around midnight, so they should be home by now. Let's head over to Tiff's house, Nas stated. I'm with that shit, I spoke. I bet your angry ass is. Look, we gonna go up in here on some calm shit until we find out what's going on with her. I just nodded because me staying calm will only happen depending on her response to the shit I needed to know. It took us about 30 minutes to get to her crib. When we got out, all we could hear was her yelling and shit crashing. What the fuck? If Tiff doesn't answer the door within a few minutes, then Cannon, you gonna have to get us in. Nas spoke, pulling his gun out. Walking up to the front door, I kicked that motherfucker in. Fuck waiting on somebody to come answer this bitch. Damn, nigga, here you go with your shit. I said give her time to answer the motherfucker first. Man, fuck that, I gritted as we walked inside. Who the fuck? Nigga, what the fuck you doing in my shit? This bitch nigga came running down the steps. Yo, Tiff, Priest called out for her. What are you guys doing here? She asked, looking at her door. We got the call that you were locked the fuck up. What you thought we were gonna be doing? Twiddling our fucking thumbs? What the hell happened? Nas asked her. This nigga is what happened. He got another bitch and baby that's only a few days younger than Anai. She was cut off by bitch boy. These niggas don't need to know our business, and they damn sure gonna have to get up out my shit. We on my turf now, motherfucker, he barked. And Nas punched that nigga in his shit. He was swinging back, but was no match for the blows Nas was giving. I know my boy had been itching to beat his ass. Priest and Sean got shit under control and pulled Nas off him. Nigga, I've been trying to give your pussy ass a pass because of your daughter. Keep talking shit, and the only thing your bitch ass gonna be spitting out is these fucking hollow tips. Tiff, finish what the hell you were saying. Nas looked at her. I caught him with his bitch and son. We got into it, and a fight broke out. For some reason, Britt and I were the only ones arrested. I don't have anyone here other than Britt for family emergencies, and she was in jail with me. I called Kelly so that she could get in touch with you to get the money. She didn't say that y'all were coming out here, she spoke, and she looked over at me. Are you pregnant? I asked, stepping into her personal space. What? Where did you hear that from? She questioned with a shaky voice. Don't fucking play with me. Are you pregnant? I roared, and she jumped. Pregnant? Why the fuck you asking if my girl pregnant? You need to get the fuck out my damn house. You niggas not gonna keep disrespecting me thinking shit sweet. I got something for your ass though, pussy, he yelled, pulling out his gun, and I chuckled. Nigga, you must wanna die. Nah, shook his head. You don't even get to talk shit when you got a whole baby out here and a bitch that's rocking the same ring as me. Fuck you. This is my shit. Like I said before, they came. You need to get all your shit and get the fuck out. She yelled at him while his gun was still pointed on me. No one made a move because they knew me and knew that I had it under control. I hate when a nigga pull his gun and don't use that shit. Man, fuck this bitch, boy. Are you pregnant? And is that my fucking baby? I asked her ass again, never breaking the stare I had on this nigga. Tiff, answer the damn question so this nigga can show his ass, because we all know what's getting ready to happen, Nas told her. Yeah, yes, I'm pregnant, and I don't know if you're the father. When this pussy realized what she was saying, he tried to charge at her, but was halted when I sent my fist crashing into his face, knocking the gun out of his hand. He tried to go toe-to-toe with me, but my ass was out for blood, and I tried to beat this nigga head in. When I said I was gonna beat his ass every time I saw him, I meant that shit. I've never wanted to kill a man as bad as I wanted this nigga in the dirt. Where's your daughter? Nas asked her. And that calmed me down a little because I really didn't want to show my ass with her kid in the house. She's upstairs. I went to pick her up from her grandmother's when I got out. She looked away, trying to avoid eye contact with me. This nigga gotta go. She doesn't want him here, and I'm tired of looking at his ass. Tiff, the next time you decide to get with a nigga, make sure the dude can protect you at all costs. This nigga ain't nothing but talk. He done got his ass beat down twice within 10 minutes, and he was the nigga with the gun, Priest told her, and made the nigga get up and get the fuck out. Go get y'all shit. You coming back to Philadelphia until you have the baby, and if you think for one second that you'll do what you did to me again, there won't be nobody that's gonna save your ass, I said to her. Now, I get that you and your feelings. However, I have a business and a life here, and my daughter's family is here. I can't just up and leave like that, and you can't come up in here tossing out demands and shit. I have no plans on doing anything to harm my baby, she snapped. Get your shit. You have 10 minutes or I'll start packing that shit for you. I don't give a damn about that pussy-ass nigga, his family, or your attitude. She could come voluntarily, or I will drag her ass out of here involuntarily. Bro, let's go outside and get some fresh air. Sean headed for the door and I walked out behind him. I was so fucking pissed that I put myself in this situation with her ass again. All I know is that she's bringing that ass back to Philly. A few minutes later, Nas came walking out of the house. Yo, we gonna have to watch out for her, dude. He's not gonna just keep getting his ass kicked and not try to come for us. Besides, now he knows you've been knee-deep in his girl. Trust me, it's not over. Priest talked to her and told her we need to keep an eye on her, and it's best that she comes back to Philly for a little while. I think she's planning to stay with him, Nas stated, and that shit ain't gonna work for me. Nah, she's staying with me, and that's the end of that, I snapped. Nigga, how you gonna move her in with you when you got your girl? What, you gonna have your maybe baby mama and your girl there at the same damn time? Nas burst out laughing. If it comes down to that, I won't be fucking with Tiff anymore, but she's staying until we can figure out if that's my kid she's carrying. Dina has her own crib. I don't think her and Tiff will be around each other much, I said to him. So you done with Tiff? That's some bullshit and you know it. You might as well end that shit with Dina because it's about to be some shit at your crib. You know Dina a messy ass chick and Tiff don't play. She gonna beat Dina's ass. Nas laughed and Sean was nodding his head in a grin. Bro, I think it's the wrong move. Maybe you should put Tiff in a house somewhere. I don't think it's a good move to bring her to your house. She's pregnant and shouldn't be stressed out. I've been trying to call Brittany's phone, and I think she's sending me the voicemail. Can you track her location for me? Sean asked, and we walked to the car so that I could grab my laptop. Wait, it was Cannon then that was doing the tracking and the fucking, and I guess Cam is the one that picked the locks. Is it Cam that picked the locks? Anyway, them two niggas be helping them breaking people's shit. Okay? Anyway. All right, so, oh, he gave me her number, and I ran it to get her location. She's at 1309 Buena Vista Avenue. That's her address, I stated. How you know that's her address? Nah, I smirked. Because when Tiff, man, nigga, fuck you, we all burst out laughing. That's what the fuck I do. I find people. Of course I knew where Tiff was laying her head when she moved here. Man, you crazy as fuck with your stalking ass. Nah, shook his head laughing at me. A few minutes later, Priest and Tiff came walking out of the house. Yo, I need y'all to drop me off to that address, Sean spoke, and we all got into the truck. And that's the end of that chapter. So now I guess Sean going to give Brittany. Oh my God, today. All right, so let me get this next timestamp. This about to be a mess. Okay, well, I like how they're moving the story to get everybody back in Philly, right? So that's cool that they moved it along like that. Let me see. This fucking timestamp ain't no joke, y'all. I just try to set it out far enough. All right. So, yeah, we just got to let that shit count down. Damn, I don't think I set it out far enough. Somebody just sent me the Buckeye emoji, yo. Y'all know when them fucking eyes be bucked out. I hate that fucking thing because it always make me laugh. It just look like surprise butt sex or something. Anyway, oh Lord, chapter 14, Sean. I came out here to make sure shit was good with baby girl, and she wasn't trying to answer my calls. I called her all times of the night, and her ass didn't have a problem picking up before. Out of courtesy, I dialed her number again as we pulled into her driveway. Oh, Lord, what the fuck is getting ready? I hope she all right. Maybe traitor kidnapped her ass. What are we doing at Britt's house? Tiff questioned, and it sounded as if her ass was a little nervous. I came here to make sure y'all was good, and now I need to lay eyes on her. Is there something I need to know before I go up in here? I asked her, because if she had a nigga in here, I guess we will be getting acquainted real soon. I don't live here, she spoke, pulling her phone out, and my brother took it, sticking it in his pocket. Give me my shit back, she yelled. Don't you see that baby girl asleep? Bro, you need me to let you in? He asked as I got out of the truck. Nah. You know what? Do your thing, big bro. It's too many cars in the driveway for my liking. Little mama only has one car. It's one too many out this bitch. I guess you don't know anything about that, huh? I looked at Tiff. Cannon got out, grabbing his kit out of his bag, and 3 minutes later, I was inside. Call if you need us. My bro dapped me up and walked back to the truck. She had a pretty decent crib from what I could see. Walking upstairs, I could hear music playing, so I decided to follow the sound to one of the bedrooms. I assumed it was her room since it was the only room with the double doors. I eased the door open, and baby girl was laying there asleep in the arms of some nigga. They were sleeping so hard, neither of them heard me come in the room. My first mind was to walk back out and not even trip off the shit with Shorty, but the thug in my ass was like, hell no, nigga, show your ass. This bitch was talking all that shit about being with me, and now she wrapped up with the next nigga. I spotted a chair in the corner of the room and took a seat as I pulled out my blunt and lit it up. Wait, pause, nigga. You walked in her crib. You broke into her crib, sir. Slipped into her bedroom. See her in the bed with a nigga. And you gonna sit down and light a blunt? Okay. I sat there and got faded for an hour watching these niggas until Britt started to stir in her sleep. She finally crawled her naked ass out of bed and was about to go to the bathroom until she noticed me sitting in the corner. She screamed and a dude jumped up and I just sat there looking at these idiots. Yo, who the fuck are you and what the fuck you want? Dude asked. Nigga, sit your punk ass down. I came here to talk to Miss Lady over there. What's up, baby girl? I spoke, and Britt turned the light on. I could tell that she hadn't realized who I was because the only little bit of light was coming from the bathroom. Sean! Oh, fuck! What are you doing out here? She stuttered. Yo, get this pussy out of here before I change my mind and beat his ass, I said to her. We weren't gonna talk about shit with his ass standing there. Pussy? I got your pussy, nigga. I laughed because this nigga sounded like a bitch. I can tell he wasn't a street nigga and he didn't understand that he was playing with his life. I was listening to For Your Glory by Tasha Cobbs on the flight over. I'm feeling a little generous right now, so I'm gonna let him rock out on that one. He better know that Tasha saved his life. Trey, I need to talk to him. Can you please leave and I'll call you? Thank you so much for bailing me out and I'll get the money back to you later today, she told him. The nigga act like he ain't wanna go, so I pulled my gun out and sat it on my lap. See, this the bullshit I'm talking about. I thought we were gonna figure this shit out, yet you got this nigga walking up in here like he the shit. Nah, you keep that change and lose my fucking number. I never fight a nigga over a bitch. That's for everybody, he yelled in her face and walked out putting his clothes on. I had to laugh at this clown ass nigga because he was pissed the fuck off. Bitch, you not gonna disrespect me because you know I will fuck you up, she yelled, and he just turned and walked out. That was the smartest move dude could have made. So, you were trying to work shit out with your nigga, huh? I'm not gonna lie, when I walked in here and saw you laid up with that nigga, I was trying to figure out what was the best way to kill y'all asses, but as I was sitting here getting faded, I thought about it. I can't be one-sided. We're not together, and I bust a few backs out since the last time I saw you. A nigga like me love to fuck, and I need pussy every day. Shit is hard for me and my little nigga out here in these streets, so it's not fair to come down on you when you live out here, and I live in Philly. You should have kept that shit gutter and got it how you live it. Stop telling me shit when you're not ready to make that move, and I can understand you wanting to take your time. Now, Had we made that shit official, both of you niggas would be on the morning news as a double homicide, a nigga on his grown man shit right now, and I'm passing out blessings. You need to thank God for looking over your life. I heard you were in trouble, and I wanted to come out here and check on you. I see you've had your legs open like the 7-Eleven. I can clearly see that you're good. I'm going back to my hotel and get some sleep. I want it, shorty, but after seeing her with old boy, I can't crawl up in the pussy and go to sleep. Sean, it wasn't like that. I didn't sleep with him, and I'm sorry you saw that. He came and bailed me out of jail and had been waiting on me for a while. I just told him he could sleep over because it was late. She felt the need to explain. Miss Lady, you don't have to explain yourself. I'm tired as fuck, and I'll probably spend most of my day sleeping. I know we're leaving here later tonight, so I'll hit your line before we head out. Oh, yeah. Tiff is moving back to Philly for a little while. I know y'all have a business together. I ordered an Uber and walked outside to wait. Sean, I'll take you to your hotel. Please, I don't want our friendship to end like this. She ran out of the house with just a t-shirt on. This isn't ending our friendship. I just don't want your ass near me with another nigga on you. You're gonna have to get that nigga off you before we can chill. I appreciate the ride to my hotel, I told her, and canceled my Uber. By the time we made it to the hotel, it was going on 7 a.m. If I take a shower, can I come in? I swear to you, I haven't had sex since I came to visit you last. I looked at her for a minute, and even though she was lying in the bed with old dude, I believed her and decided to let her come up with me. When I got out of the shower, I ordered some breakfast for us. I'm going to jump in the shower, she smiled. Yeah, you do that. I climbed into bed, and it wasn't long before I drifted off to sleep. I felt a cool breeze hit my dick and the sensation like I was about to bust a nut. That shit had me ready to tear some pussy up. Opening my eyes, Brittany was in between my legs, giving me that sloppy head. Shit, girl, suck that motherfucker, I gritted. The way her head was bobbing up and down and the grip she had on my dick was about to make my ass explode. Mm-hmm. Bust in my mouth, baby. Shit, she didn't have to tell me twice. She was deep-throating my dick so good, cum shot out of me so fast and hard, I thought I was gonna choke her ass. God damn, I gritted. Once I gathered my composure, I got up, grabbing the condoms out of my bag and sheathing my dick. Pulling her to the edge of the bed, I rubbed my dick up and down her slit. Ooh, shit, she moaned as I dug in her walls. Lil' mama was gonna pay for having that nigga in her crib. Shut up and take this dick, I gritted. Slamming into her ass over and over again. Sean, pull out. Oh, God, it's too much. I can't take it. Nah, you been showing your ass lately. Got that nigga laying up in your shit like that's your man. You been fucking him, Britt? I was so deep in her pussy, it felt like I touched her damn rib cage. No, I promise I didn't. I've only been with you. Oh, my God, it feels so good, she moaned. I pulled out of her and flipped her over to hit it from the back. She gripped my dick as I slid inside of her, pounding the hell out of her pussy. Damn, it's some good pussy. Sean, please pull out. It's hurting me, she cried, and I stopped moving. Baby girl, you good? I asked her because she was sitting here in tears. No, I'm in pain and my stomach is killing me. I felt bad because she seemed like she was in a lot of pain. You want to go to the emergency room? I asked her as I rubbed her stomach. No, I just want to lay here and hopefully it'll go away. Girl, it'll go away as soon as he stuffed that dick back in there. That pain coming back, bitch. Baby, I came to that bitch. Probably got a fucking bruised ass cervix or some shit. Cause I heard them big dicks be bruising cervixes and shit. That's what I heard. Stay out my goddamn business. Anyway, I cleaned myself up and left out to go get her to go get her something to take for the pain. My phone was going off and I saw that it was my brother calling. What up? I answered. Mom just called me and said Sadie's moved out. Man, I talked to Mercedes and she told me she wasn't gonna move in with his ass. I'll get up with her when we get back. What time we heading back? Everybody's tired. We're going to leave tomorrow. Tiff has to handle some business before she leaves, so you're good. He sounded stressed the fuck out. I'm already at the hotel and Brittany's with me, but she's not feeling well. I'll catch up with y'all later. I'm going back to bed. I ended the call with my brother and grabbed the shit that I needed from the hotel gift shop. And that's the end of that chapter. Ciao. trust and believe them big dick danglers will bruise your fucking service. Cause baby, we be trying to get it all and take it all. Oh Lord, have mercy. And them mugs be trying to fucking, I don't know if they be drilling for oil or what the fuck. It looks like, sir. I mean, I like it rough. You know what I'm saying? But goddamn, when I say ouch, nigga, like that means some shit. Let me talk about some gnaw. Gnaw? The fuck? Say gnaw again and watch me clench. Break your shit off. What Martin say? God, clench it up and break your shit off. Oh my God, I will break your shit in two, sir. What you not finna do is be fucking my cervix up. Shit. Hell. Let me giving the pussy a black eye. Chapter 15, Tiff. I can't believe all the shit that was going on right now. I find out that my fiance is a lying piece of shit. I'm pregnant and don't know whose damn baby I'm having. If that ain't some whole shit, I don't know what is. I have a lot of things to figure out when it comes to Anaya seeing her dad and her grandmother. Cannon is pissed and he hasn't said much to me since we got to the hotel. He wouldn't let me get my own room. I tried going into the room with Nas or Priest and he was raising hell about that. After my shower, I stepped into the room and was shocked to see him holding and feeding my daughter. She woke up crying while you were in the shower. Thank you for getting her for me. I smiled because he was so attentive with her. It was as if she calmed him. Child, don't nothing calm that crazy nigga down. That nigga's crazy. Okay, so, said, right, you just gotta take it slow and not frequent. Oh, I don't know what that means. I don't know what that means. No comprende. No habla inglés. What is this thing you call slow and not frequent? I don't know what that means, because girl, no God. Sorry. Don't you know I'm greedy, said. Okay. I walked over to take her from him, and he didn't want me to take her. I ordered you lunch. It's on the table. He nodded in the direction of the food, and I walked over to eat. I hope Anaya goes back to sleep, because I was still exhausted, and it was only 1 p.m. I could feel him staring a hole through me, and I turned to look at him, because he never stopped staring. What? His stare was making me uncomfortable. Were you ever going to tell me? He questioned as he stood to put the baby in her travel crib. Yes, I just found out yesterday, right before I got into the fight with Marlo. Cannon, I was going to call you. I just needed time to process it all. I was in shock. Not knowing who the father of your child is a messed up situation to be in. I know you don't trust me, but I would never put either of us through that again. It was the worst mistake of my life. You're right, I don't trust you. If you didn't fuck up and you were sure that baby was mine, I can almost bet that you would have been at the closest abortion clinic. So no, I don't trust your ass, and that's why you stand with me until we find out for sure. His words cut deep, and there was nothing for me to say. I got up and went into the bathroom because I couldn't hold back the tears. There was a time where this man would have given me anything, and I fucked it up. I got myself together and walked out of the bathroom. He was still sitting in the same spot. Walking over to check on my baby, she was peacefully sleeping. Mentally, I was drained, and I just needed to get my mind right. I was hurt yet again, putting my trust into another nigga that wasn't shit. I know Cannon may think I deserve the shitty-ass attitude that he's giving me, and he might be right. It's just not the right time, and if this is what I have to deal with, being with him, he can forget about me staying in his house. Yo, why the hell are you calling me when we were just texting? I told you I'll be home tomorrow night, and after I'm done handling my business, I'm coming straight to you. I heard him speak, and it sounded as if he was talking to a woman. When he said that he loved her, that validated that he was indeed talking to a woman. I had no idea that he was involved with someone. Well, why the fuck would you, ma'am? You ran your ass off to go be with Pencil Dick. Anyway, I felt a rush of anger come over me. I didn't even want to be in the room with him right now. What? Anyway, I jumped up, putting my shoes on, and walked out of the room without saying shit to him. I had no right to be mad, but I was pissed. I needed to vent, so I called Cass. Hey, you all right? She asked. I'm good, just in my feelings a little bit. I just found out that Cannon has a girl, and for some reason that shit pissed me off, I said to her. Tiff, what did you expect him to do? You went back to Cali to live your life with your man and baby. You made a choice that didn't include him. Hell, you did a lot of shit that didn't include him. some of the shit I don't understand, and I'm not the one to sugarcoat this shit for you. You were wrong, sis, and nothing is gonna change the fact that you fucked up. I'm not gonna keep beating you over the head about it, but you know damn well you can't be mad at him. I've never known Cannon to play second best to nobody. Let me tell you how God showed out on this one. You came home with your man and new baby. You end up in bed with the man that your heart really belongs to, and then go back to your life on some settling shit with Puss Boy. I'm sorry, she called his ass Puss Boy. Oh, Lord. The reason you're pregnant now and the reason you caught Bitch Boy on his ain't shit nigga shit is only because God stepped in. Well, God doesn't condone cheating. This was an emergency and I'm glad he showed up. Now, Cannon wants you to come live with him until y'all can find out if that's his baby. Girl, you better go up in that motherfucking house and show the fuck out. Dina is there because he's settling. You bruised his heart. She's a placement holder until his true desire could get her shit together. Walk around that bitch half damn naked if you have to. Tell his ass clothes give you the hives or some shit. Now, if your confused ass still don't know what you want, leave him alone and let him move on. Keep that wicked ass pussy to yourself, bitch. Got this nigga out here losing his damn mind. I gotta go. My man is calling me. I'll see you tomorrow. She didn't even give me time to respond. She just hung up. Just as I was about to go back into the room, I saw Sean walking out of his room carrying a girl in his arms. Oh, shit. Britt, what's wrong? I ran up to them because she was screaming that she was in pain. This nigga and his dick is what's wrong. Girl, if you know what's best for you, don't fuck Cannon. These niggas is on some hateful ass revenge type shit. Got me out here about to be pussyless. Go back to the other side, sis, where fucking with bitches is safe. Oh, she screamed, and Sean was shaking his head. I'm taking her to see her doctor. We'll call you when we get back, he spoke. Bro, what's going on? I heard Cannon ask from behind me. She's not feeling well. I'll call y'all as soon as we get back to the room. He rushed off with Brittany still going off, and I couldn't help but laugh at her crazy ass. Turning to walk back into the room, he grabbed my arm and pinned me against the wall. Lose the attitude. You created this shit, now deal with it. Jerking out of his embrace, I walked back inside of our room and laid down for a nap. And that's the end of that chapter. Child, listen, Linda. I don't even know what the fuck is happening right now. Oh, my God. Everybody all fucked up out the game and shit. So what the hell? All right, y'all. That's it. We're going to stop right here and call it a night. And I'm going to see y'all tomorrow. Because, yes, honey, she talking about he gave her too much too fast. Well, I could see if she was choking, but this ain't that. Well, maybe her cootie cat is choking. I don't know, but yeah. No. You, not. Y'all ain't shit, bro. Nope. Here we go. Go to hell. Every single one of you, go to hell. No. That's it. We done, y'all, for real. Okay. She goes, come on, L Boogie, don't do that. Tell me, just crushed my feelings. Jay, nah. Come on, Peanut. Y'all bogus for that. So listen, y'all, we're going to stop right here and pick this up tomorrow. She's talking about dancing outside in the rain. Yup. I told y'all. No. Okay, so listen. Thank y'all for listening to me read out loud. Right, gotta go. That part. Okay. Listen, said I already know. No, I didn't leave for no damn 1 week. Peanut, stop lying. I was just here Saturday. I was gone Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. That's it. So don't do me like that. She talking about I'm gone for a week. Y'all is crazy. Aw, don't be like that, girl. All right? So listen, we're going to pick this back up tomorrow. We'll start off tomorrow with the next chapter, okay? And finish this thing right on up. She talking about Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Girl, somebody felt like a week. Irk a jerk. Go to hell. Child, listen. I know, right? I know. Y'all better get out of here. Listen. Nope. I'm sorry, y'all. I got to go. For real. Listen, I did too, right? I thought today was Thursday too. Oh, Peanut. Don't do me. She gonna say, and this how you do. You go to hell, Kim. All of y'all crazy. All right, so listen. Thank y'all for listening to me read out loud, okay? I hope I left y'all feeling better than you were when you got here, all right? Y'all have a good night, okay? And I love y'all. So y'all stay safe, okay? And if you do nothing else, please salute your spirit and protect your peace. Until next time, bye y'all.